Ah, shit. Here we go again. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the stream. The non-bully stream. It's imperative to remember that for this one, because today we're talking about somebody who multiple people have warned me will probably try to swat me or community strike me. So this is going to be a very exciting stream. Get your F keys ready. Don't spam it yet, but it could happen at any moment. Get a few more Yakuza tunes going there. That song was a scattered moment from Yakuza 2, the final boss theme, I think, which, man, rest in peace, Ryuji. But yeah, this is going to be an interesting stream. This is somebody that I learned about recently. I think somebody mentioned her in the comments for yesterday's stream, and I'd heard about this woman before, but I never exactly I never exactly paid much attention to her. Like I'd passed by her thread in passing on Kiwi Farms, and I never really paid much attention to it, but I did this time because people informed me that she's like a child abuser and crazy. Now, I don't know, I'm not making any accusations here, and this is not a bully stream, but this is what some people have told me, so we're going to be investigating some of those claims. I've got some timestamps where certain activities are said to be taking place. From what I understand, the woman that we're talking about today, her name is Amy Ramadan. I'm not sure what her real name is. I know her docs are out there. I'm not going to say where you can find them, but you can find them if you want to. I'm not suggesting that you do that, but I don't know what her full name is, but they call her Amy Ramadan, and maybe that is her legal name. I don't know, and she is a mother of, you might even say, MommyOthree, as I put it in the video title. She is a mother of three who kind of, she's like a mommy vlogger, basically. She's like one of those people who fashions her identity around, this is just my opinion anyway, fashions her identity around having babies, not children, but babies. Because once children, you know, gain independence and, like, sentience, they stop being cute. But when she has babies, that can be her identity. That's just my take. I don't know. That's my opinion. But, yeah, she's like a beauty channel. She's, morbidly obese. Those are her words, not mine. She's like 500 pounds, I think. She wears a hijab because she's a Muslim convert, I believe. What else is there to say about her? I guess she, well, you know, here's the thumbnail, of course. She has a car toilet. I don't know, it's like a potty, I think. It's for the chillums. It's for the kids. But, yeah, car toilet. As you do. Let's see. She's got, what else is there? Well, here are some lovely pictures that she's made of herself, in MS Paint. Of her in a hijab. I guess these are without the hijab, initially. So she decided to, you know, fashion up this bad boy. And I don't know about you, but I think this is, I buy it. You got this one. You know, this is some quality stuff. This is, she has, I could see her working at Microsoft in the future. But yeah, she's like, this is her that did this, apparently. She MS painted a hijab on, I guess. But that's her. That's our girl. What else do we have here? We got this one. This is a good one. This is a very good one. She spent time on this. Like, she got it to contour along with the guy's face pretty well. It's admirable, honestly. Let's see. I think that's enough of that for now. I forgot to get rid of the stream cert. Fucking hell. The stream has begun, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the stream. Let's see. Well, here's the famous picture of her with the spoon. Apparently, she uses this spoon. It's being suggested that she uses the spoon to hit the kids. Now, as I say, she is like a beauty vlogger. If you I don't want to bully, but if you can believe that, she's a beauty vlogger, and she documents a lot of her life on her channel, and a lot of the channel has like the kids screaming. And she's just kind of ignoring them. You can see them in the background. They're like, their hair is like crazy and long and disheveled. And there's sometimes where there's actual evidence, like you can see it. She hits the kid. I don't know. We're going to take a look. I haven't seen too much of it. I wanted to do sort of a first impression stream. But yeah, she's a YouTuber, everybody. So we're going to be looking at some YouTube videos today. Now, before we do that, though, this is going to be minor boomer energy for a moment here. I just need to set up a thing to watch. Which video? You know what? Fuck it. We'll do this in a little bit. We'll do this in a little bit. Let's go over here. Turn off the Yakuza music. And we're going to get started here with a video called, what is it called? I think it's called Let's Go to Portland, if I'm not mistaken. And, this is one which I believe she deleted from her YouTube, because she likes to delete everything, in addition to swatting people and, community striking them. She likes to delete a lot of her videos, But this one, I believe is supposed to be evidence of what she's like done, apparently. I don't know. We'll see. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe this whole stream will turn out to be an error, a fault. I'll realize that she's done nothing wrong and we can't judge her. But before we do this, I should get into a couple of super chats here. Also, before we do this, I should drink some, because I've got a spiced whiskey right now, and it's pretty good, honestly. It's not the chocolate whiskey, but it's the same brand. But I guess it's fine. Maybe I should just add some like fucking Nesquik to this. I bought some like ice cream topping chocolate syrup today. Maybe I should just add some of that. That'd probably be pretty good. But, very nice. Let's see here. 12 minutes ago, we got Fuzu with $2. Happy almost Valentine's Day, nerds. Happy almost Valentine's Day. I know I plan on spending my Valentine's Day playing Yakuza 5. It's gonna be a good time. Probably gonna woo some of the girls at the hostess clubs. Big plans, as you can tell. 99 cents from Rach. No message. Thank you. $10 from Goof Troop. Are you finna make me goof tonight, Claw Zaddy? I feel pretty bad reading that, but yes, we're gonna get goofy. We're gonna goof it the fuck up. $2 from Mama Catswell. I preferred the spinoff over the sequel. I'm not sure what that means, but hang on. Actually, we should get the Yakuza music happening again, now that I think about it. There you go. $2 from Fuzu. By the way, Claw hasn't finished Silent Hill 2. No, I got to like the apartments and then I kind of stopped. I should probably continue it, but there's a lot of games, you know? I'm sorry. I have every Yakuza game to replay because I'm weird and a weeaboo. £2 from Joe Cameron, just in time for the stream. Love you, Daddy Claw. I hope you enjoy the stream. Buckle up for some garbage. $5 from Cat Boundary. Just found this lady's KF thread. Been tweeting about her. She's been reported, but as usual, YouTube ain't done nothing. Get him, Papa Bear. Well, there was a comment earlier that apparently, and I don't know, it might have been a joke or something, but it got apparently deleted by a Google moderator. So that's interesting. I guess hello to the Google moderator in chat if that's happening. Let's see. Peg me, Papa Bear. Hi, Google Mod. Yeah, well, I would like to say to the Google moderator, we're not a bully stream. I'm just showing some stuff that's happening on the internet. Occasionally, I make a couple jokes, but it's all in good fun. Yeah, you know, if this lady's abusing her kids, you know, it would be a shame if you did something to me before you did something to her. That's all I'm going to say about that. But, let's see. $2 from Diana Morse. Is this a weird gender bend of Daddy 05? No, this is just kind of a new version of Daddy 05. Where Daddy 05 profited off of the beating of their children and the tormenting of their children, this lady's just sort of using the status of having babies and children and being a mommy as, like, clout, I guess. And the actual well-being of the kid seems to be pretty secondary, but, you know, again, that's just what I've heard. This has been making some people in my Discord pretty mad, so I don't know. This might be something kind of like Daddy 05, but I don't think it's quite as bad. $5 from Fal Your Pal. I love when Daddy doesn't bully people. I've been bullying online this whole time, lol. I mean, we're definitely not a bully stream. We don't bully people. That's a bad idea. That would be against the YouTube TOS. To point out and criticize people for the things that they do that are, you know, not the greatest. You know, maybe not the greatest. Maybe telling somebody that they shouldn't abuse their children is against the rules. I'm not sure. $2 from Ash Ketchum 442. Do you get along with Lord Bear? I'm not sure who that is, but, you know, I'm sure if he's a fellow bear, he's probably not an asshole, you know? $2 from Fidgety Penguin. She's scaring me, Dork. Protect us, please. What could possibly be scaring you about this? What could possibly be making you upset or frightened? $5 from Sean Hiruki. I know I'll be spending Valentine's and this weekend watching Anime Ascension and playing Warriors Orochi 4 Ultimate. You really play that garbage? You play the okay. Yeah, I never got into the Musos. I'm sorry. I guess that one's a little better than the other one, but yeah, it would be interesting to see that genre taken on by somebody who isn't pretty much incompetent in making games. but to each their own. $5 from Cecile A. Kate Winslet's video, do I need to get a spoon? Yes, we might be looking at the Kate Winslet channel. I understand that does some clips and such of some of this lady's stuff. I feel like that might be a good palate cleanser, maybe. Let's see. Finally, $5 from Raven Hollow. Evening, Claw Papa. I actually got Yakuza 0 because of you. Can't wait to get into it. Well, that's nice to hear. I would say, you know, really take it in. Pay attention to it. And if you get to the part where Majima is introduced and you're not already sold on the game, as I always tell everybody, if the 20 something minute cutscene where he's introduced doesn't sell you on the series, I don't know, it just might not be the series for you. Also, we got $5 here from Danny Devoid. Would you taste MommyOthree's neck rust, aka unwashed dermatosis,
where the dirt and dead skin cells build up in the folds for $1,000. $1,000? Do you really think I'm that cheap of a whore? I mean, I'm a whore, but I'm an expensive whore. Not $1,000, thank you very much. Probably not $1,000,000, but you know, we'll just move along from that. So that's it's a good song to be playing at this point in time. It's called Unrest. That's great. So this is Amy's life journey. I think that's the name of her channel, actually. And this is like a 30-minute vlog where she's going to Portland. I think she's thanking people for 600 subs or something like that. I'm not sure. But from what I understand, the weird shit starts happening around the 20-something minute mark. So we're going to be watching for a few minutes here. We're going to see what goes down. And again, this is a perfectly fair use. Do we have the fair use boys up? We need to have those fair use boys up on the screen. We need those boys. Well, it's just one boy right now, but it's fine. We need the fair use bear. Hang on. Fair use bear. There you go. This is a fair use stream. This is also not a bully stream. We're not bullying anybody. We are just exposing the facts and the things that have been posted by the people in the nation. I don't know what I'm saying anymore. Let's watch the video. Play. Oh no, play the video. You fuck, play it. What? Okay, well, technical difficulties. There you go.
Squeeze me.
I would prefer not to.
Oh, maybe because it's a... I have no idea. I don't know what I'm squeezing, but...
Oh, Sangi, you're right. Well, we don't need Sangi yet. We don't know if this is a Sangi stream.
Okay. It's not the stretchy back like it's supposed to be, though. It said that it had a band around it. No, it doesn't. So, I don't know. I can try it and see.
So you can hear the kids in the background.
I have one on, and what that noise is. It is so comfortable, but...
Remember, chat, it would be bad of you to start making jokes about her appearance. That would be wrong. This isn't a bully stream, so don't do that, okay?
This one, for some reason, I cannot get it, you guys. But it's just a matter of me positioning it.
That would be bad.
And it will go up. So these... I really think we'll be a winner once
I get that back up.
Okay, so one thing that's interesting is that she does edit the videos. That's a thing that some people have noted. Again, full props to the Kiwi Farms thread. I have it linked in the description there. We're going to be looking at a few. One, actually. I had some notes that I had saved, but then my computer crashed and I lost all my notes. But I had a couple quotes that I wanted to read. But one... in particular that I made sure to get again from a Kiwi Farms post. I think the thread is from somebody named Strawberry Douche, if I'm not mistaken, who has done a lot of good work there. So, you know, full props to them for finding a lot of this stuff. But yeah, one thing that some people have noted is that she does, in fact, edit her videos. But what's interesting is some of the stuff you're about to see that she apparently chose not to edit. I don't know. We're going to see what happens.
But I'll just have to manipulate it for a little bit.
I heard it happens around the 26-minute mark.
We'll get it to work.
That's what I've heard.
I'm not worried about it. But I want to show you guys. Oh, and that other shirt that I was telling you was on my bed. Ooh. Let's see. What brand is this one?
Breathing heavily.
Oh, maybe it doesn't have a brand on it.
Inhales. Boy!
Because this 2, I want to say it's like a 5X. And this one ain't no 5X. It's more like a 2X. I mean, honestly, it goes over me, but it is tight. So, I don't know. I mean, this one might surprise me and totally fit me, but I'll let you guys know. I'll try it on better and show you guys if it's doable. I'll show you what it looks like. So, broken nail, putting my shoe on. Good times. Anyways, all right, you guys, I'm going to close my vlog so I can go take a shower.
So you might have noticed that she's got the hijab going here. We're not going to be making any comments about anybody's choice of religion, although it does seem interesting for a woman to choose to be, well, anyways, but, you know, that's fine. Anybody, you can make your choices, but, one thing that I've heard from some people is that apparently the hijab that she's wearing is, like, not even a proper hijab. It's kind of like the scarf thing that goes underneath, it's kind of like the underwear of the hijab, apparently. So, it's like not even, she's not actually apparently even doing it right. And from what people have said, she doesn't really wash it that often. So, you know, keep that in mind.
I'm so hot, sticky, and ready for bed. So, anyways, I hope that you guys enjoyed my vlog today. And I will check in with you guys tomorrow, bright and shiny, let you guys know when my doctor's appointment
bright
is.
And shiny.
Yay! Until then, sweet dreams, you guys. Bye-bye. And I wanted to thank you guys so much.
I think this is the part. People said she was talking about her 600 subscribers or something, and this is where it happens.
Every one of you that have brought me to 600 subscribers, I am so ecstatic. I am so happy. You guys have no idea. When I seen that I am at 600 subscribers, I was like, something is going well.
You can hear a child in the background.
And it just made my heart skip a beat and me sing a song, because I am so happy to see my channel growing, because not only is it you guys that are making this happen, but this is also your guys' channel, and that's why I get so excited, because I know that you guys are getting...
Okay, so now the child is screaming and the mom's just not paying any attention to it.
Meet new people just like I am. So anyways, I just wanted to thank you guys so much for all of the support, encouragement. Excuse her. She is not the support I need right now.
My screaming daughter who needs help is not the support that I need right now, guys. Don't you see what a problem that child is being?
But anyways, I just wanted to thank you guys from the bottom of my heart for all of the support that you guys give me. This is an amazing opportunity that you guys have also helped me reach. And that...
Okay, now notice something.
Reach...
Notice the way her face changes. She goes from like, thank you guys, thank you all so much. And then she just changes.
And that.
And she just like goes into like a bad, like, I don't know. She goes like fucking Liam Neeson Taken mode. What's happening now?
You do not scream like that. You go out right now. No, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you.
Well, that's not really footage of her beating the kids.
Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart for helping.
I guess we heard a smack. Did we hear a smack? Let's go hit that through the rewind real quick.
You do not.
Okay, there is a smack. That sounds like a smack. So it sounds like the daughter is like crying for some reason. And the mom doesn't ask her at all why she's crying or, like, what happened or if she hurt herself or what is going on. She just walks up to the kid and smacks her and then screams at her. And also she decided to, like, record this. She decided in like, specifically to leave this in. Let's rewind this again.
You do not.
Yeah, you hear the door open, you hear the smack, and then she starts screaming, and the daughter starts crying.
Don't scream like that. You go out right now, no, ma'am.
No, ma'am. Now there's some people that had the theory that this was left in the video.
like specifically edited into the video, because some people say that her kids are screaming all the time in her videos, which is apparently true. We're going to see that in a bit. But people say that her kids are screaming all the time. And I guess she wanted to like prove to them maybe that she disciplines them. But I don't know, when your daughter's just screaming and you're making your video, and like, what's crazy is she's editing the video. She could have just stopped recording and gone and said like, hey, what's wrong? Did you hurt yourself? Do you, you know, what's happening? But the daughter's just like crying, and she just goes and smacks the kid, apparently. So that's not so cool. I don't know about that one.
I just want to thank you guys so much from the bottom of my heart for helping me reach 600 subscribers.
Oh, she reached the 600, guys. So that's some child abuse right there. That's super cool. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Amy. Very cool. Let's move on to... Oh, well, she has the child who has been confirmed. So she has this kid, right? And apparently the child is not actually like wasn't adopted through legal means. That's what's being said. The child was acquired through somewhat shady means. This is what I've heard. And she goes into detail about this child. Yeah, apparently she had a friend who just, like, gave her a kid, and there was not really any paperwork or anything, and the kid's not a U.S. citizen, apparently. This has been, like, recently confirmed that the kid is not a U.S. citizen. Somebody says this is some mommy dearest shit, and you're right. This is basically what that is. Your mom just kind of going off the handle and snapping at you when you look to your parent for comfort and like guidance and safety, and she just like beats you and tells you to stop crying and doesn't even ask you what you did or what happened to you. That's definitely gonna lead to some fucked up children in the future. But yeah, so she has this kid who apparently she... before we get to the mystery kid, before we get to the kid who is not a U.S. citizen and was just acquired and was not legally adopted, apparently this has been confirmed. This is what I'm hearing is confirmed. I don't have the proof, but apparently it exists. I don't know. You can look it up. But this is what's being said. Before we look at that, though, I do have one thing I'd like to do. See if we can just open this.
So I don't know what to do because I don't want to...
So this is apparently a video where she beats... Or she threatens to beat the kids with a spoon or something? I'm not sure. Let's watch.
Get on a point where I have to have the caffeine. Because that's not how I've ever ran my body. Like, I've never gotten attached to something where my body has to have it in order to, like... function or whatever it might be.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know what I'm gonna do. I told Ollie that I was thinking I might just go ahead and
Ollie is the
go
husband,
through the
I
withdrawal
believe.
Caffeine. What, honey? What? Huh? I don't. Okay, hold on. Okay.
Hold on with your crying, child. I'm doing more important things.
Okay. So I'm wondering if I might have to go through like the withdrawal headaches to get it back out of my system again. No. Okay, Omar, do I need to get the spoon?
Does she need to get the spoon?
Okay, then you need to stop. I carry this with me everywhere I go.
Uh-huh.
Do I ever use it? Nope. Do I threaten it? Yep.
Do we believe that she doesn't use it? By the way, I know there's probably jokes to be had about this lady and spoons, but... Do we believe that she doesn't? I don't know. The spoon leaves some fucking marks, and the kids look pretty terrified when she... When she brings out the spoon.
Okay, then you need to stop. I carry this with me everywhere I go. Do I have...
The kids look kind of fucking scared. I don't know. It's a little bit... So, you know, at the very bare minimum, you've got the children crying here, and they've got some problem, and the mom refuses to just pause the recording and just help the kids and ask them what's going on and fix their problem. Like, the kids very much seem to come second in this relationship. So that's definitely very alarming, to see from a parent, especially a parent who apparently used to run a daycare. This lady ran a daycare. That's what people have said. So keep that in mind. This caring, wonderful person apparently ran a daycare. So this video that we're going to watch now, I don't know what the timestamps are in this. It's 25 minutes long almost, so fucking buckle in. But this is apparently her explaining how she acquired this child through very sketchy means. Again, I'm pretty sure this one was deleted because she deletes fucking everything. The moment she realizes after she posts it and people tell her, hey, that was a bad idea, she's like, oh, maybe I should delete it. But she doesn't have the thought to not post it before she, you know, makes an ass of herself. Not a bully stream, but anyways. Wow, this is some cheese.
Hey guys, you're probably thinking, gosh, I just seen you just a second ago and you're still wearing the same clothes. But
no, I'm actually probably thinking it's ironic how much you look like a ham despite being never mind, that's bullying.
Sorry. Just wanted to talk to you guys about something. I've had a lot of questions and I figured this is the time to go ahead and make this video, and that way I can fill you guys in and answer your guys's questions that I'm sure you guys have going through your mind, and that way then it will be a big elephant out of the room that are things that you guys are thinking about, I'm
right,
sure.
The Google mod is here.
So this story is about...
It's okay to bully a little tiny Jeremiah bit to make some a couple jokes. We're not even bullying. It's jokes.
He is my little lovebird.
When somebody's a child abuser, that's okay.
He is 10. He'll be 11 get at least in one. April. Can't believe it. My baby. Oh, he's getting too old for mama.
Did I mention to you guys that this lady has an emotional support skunk? Did I mention that to you guys? Because she does. We're going to look into that.
But he's a little sweetheart. So the story that goes behind my little boy is that as a little girl, I always wanted to adopt a baby. I always wanted to give a baby love and safety and protection, and It was always a dream of mine. And
well, you know, Amy, there's still time, but somehow I don't know if I believe that.
So I always knew in the back of my mind I was going to do foster care.
You believe this music in the background, Chad?
Knowing, because I was in the system myself. My situation was a lot different than most foster care children in the sense that I was placed with family, and some of the family were strangers to me, though. I didn't know some of them, but it was okay. You know, at least I was still with family and I wasn't with a complete actual stranger. But I always knew I wanted to help.
Shut up, John Doe. I'm not a bully. I'm just an internet reporter. I'm totally unbiased.
When I was...
Guys, believe me.
25. I had talked to a couple of my family members. Mm-hmm. They are from the islands,
but they
live here in the United States. And I
shared the islands.
My dream of wanting to raise a baby. And, you know, I don't feel like you always have to have that perfect family, the mom, the dad, and the children to make a complete family. I think family is about love.
Yeah.
Support.
I also agree with that. I agree. You should make sure that you love and support your children when they're crying and don't beat them. For interrupting your stupid YouTube
video.
Embracing
each other. It doesn't... To me, as long as The circle is complete between whomever is compared to that family. That makes the family.
So if it's a parent, the islands.
Children, that's a family. If it's a dad and his children, it's a family. If it's two partners,
it's Kazuma Kiryu and the Morning Glory Orphanage, that's a family.
If there's a mom and a dad and children, that's also a family. So just because, you know, I didn't have the whole layout, you know, that most adoption agencies here in the United States expect to have, which would be, you know, you have to have everything in line. I mean, to adopt a baby here in the United States, it cost starting about $20,000. And I would never have that amount of money, you know.
So in other words, to legally go through the process that you legally need to go through in order to legally do this, you would need to spend money. So instead you decided to, okay, I'm with you so far.
Want to feel like I was purchasing a baby. I didn't want to feel like I had to go into a supermarket to buy a baby. I wanted to get a baby that needed the home, the love, the life that they deserved, without having to slap down thousands of dollars that I didn't even have. So I started talking to a few people and just kind of putting the word out there that, you know, I would just love to have a baby of my own. I want a baby so...
I just started talking to some people, putting the word out there, you know, spreading a couple feelers, you know, just seeing if anybody, maybe, you know, their daughter got knocked up by the pool boy or their dad, you know, hey, I'm not judging it, you know, inbreeding, you know, that just makes them more sympathetic for me. But, you know, any unwanted children in your, you know, your general, like in your village, you know, maybe I could trade them for a goat or something.
Bad of my own. And I was told that I would never have children at the very beginning of my adult life. I was told that my cycles were completely off, and
doesn't she have like three weight, doesn't she have kids that she
it would just
gave birth
it was a
to
pretty much shut door for me from the get-go that I would never have kids. So that fear already had set in that I would just never be that mom that I always dreamed to be. So taking a leap of faith, I started, you know, spreading the word that you know, I would just love to have a baby. I just want to have a baby to call my own and to
She's like trying to, I don't know, like there's all this sympathetic music in the background and she's trying so hard to like make it seem okay that you basically just like illegally adopted a child. And also the way that she keeps going off about, I just want to have a baby. I just wish I could have a baby. It's like, this woman doesn't really want to be a parent. She wants to just have a baby. She wants to be a mommy to a baby. I think that's all she wants. I remember like years and years ago, it was like 2010 or something. I think my mom was watching like E.T. or something. Not E.T. It was one of the entertainment shows like what are they called? I don't care. One of the entertainment shows. And one of the fucking talking heads was at some premiere or whatever. And she looked at like Beyonce. And I think Beyonce recently gave birth. And she was like, Beyonce's rocking her newest accessory. And it's like the baby. And I was like, wow, that's a really shitty way to talk about anybody or think about life. Holy shit. Wow, that's disgusting. So I feel like that might be a little bit of the sort of syndrome that this lady has, where it's like, it's not so much about parenting the children and actually supporting them, but it's about like the feeling that she gets sort of from having the baby or the status of having the baby.
Life with and make the life of this baby the best that it could be. And about 7 months later, a friend of mine called me. And she says, Amy. I said, what? And she said,
got a bit of a problem.
And I was like, okay. I was like, what's up? You know, and
the pill didn't work.
This person, you know, she didn't really always call me. So I thought that was kind of odd, but I for sure wasn't expecting for her to tell me what she was going to tell me. And she says, well, I have a sister that is back home and she's pregnant right now. but they're not going to be able to keep the baby. And I was like, oh my gosh. I was like, wow, how sad. I was like, wow, so what is she going to do? And she says, well, I talked to my sister and I told her about
you. These are the people from back home on the islands, everybody.
You know, everything. And my sister wants to give her baby to you. And my heart.
She just wants to give you the baby. My sister also doesn't know that the law exists.
And I sat there for a minute and I was like,
babies work like currency, right? Like you can trade them like Yu-Gi-Oh cards or something, right?
Repeat that? She says, my sister wants to give you her baby because she knows that she can't give that baby everything that this baby needs because she's already got children.
Mm-hmm.
And she's just in a position where she just can't keep this baby.
Right.
And I was like, oh my gosh.
So it's sort of like when you left this very same child that you're talking about right now, when you left them like God knows where and you went gallivanting around in Egypt with your new husband around Christmas time. And you fucked off in Egypt, and then you came back, and I think it was supposed to be Christmas Eve that you came back home. Your kid, Jeremiah, the one that you acquired, the one who joined your party, like a JRPG, was left without Christmas presents. You came home, and you paraded around a pregnancy test, hoping that you got pregnant, because from what somebody says, again, on Kiwi Farms, she really wanted to get pregnant because her Christmases are always so bad, and it would make her Christmas better if she had another child who she could allegedly neglect. So that's a story of something that happened with this child that she acquired. As you can see, it's a very loving and caring home. Once she acquired the child, you know, she had the kid. And it made her look like she cared or something. And then she was, I guess, able to just leave the kid at home or whatever while she went and did her thing. And then she came back home and focused on herself and her next kid, who's, you know, a baby and smaller and cuter. And just kind of ignored Jeremiah. But we're going to look at that video probably next. I don't know. Has she said enough about this?
Really? And I definitely put my guards up immediately because I didn't want to get excited. I didn't want...
So she basically admitted to, I don't want to pay the $20,000 or whatever price it is. I don't want to pay the money to actually adopt a child. So I just started asking some people from the islands, from out of the country, some random people, that if they want to give me their child... And now she has a son who's, like, not legally hers and is not legally under her care and is also not a U.S. citizen. That's not very good.
No, but
we'll give this video another minute or two, and then we're going to jump into the video about her neglectful Christmas, allegedly.
It was just talk at this point, you know, and I was just, all these thoughts started racing through my mind, and... You know, oh my gosh, this is so exciting. And I was just starting to get my blood pumping. And then I was like, whoa, Amy, pull back a little bit. Pull back. We don't want to get hurt. So I said, oh my gosh, okay. I said, well, how far along is she? You know, does she, not that it matters, does she know the sex of the baby? All the questions are coming out. And she says, well, she's due to have the baby in 3 weeks. And I was like, oh my gosh. I was like, wow. I really wasn't expecting this. And she says, we're not sure of the sex of the baby. And I was like, it doesn't matter. It doesn't even matter. I don't care. And she says, but I'll call you more with some more details. And I said, okay. So I set the phone down and I just, you know, of course all these feelings just start flooding in. And
okay, so fine. She got the she acquired the child. Once again, the child joined her party, and she acquired the child. So what's next? Let's see. Let me take a look at my text file here. Oh yeah, there's the time when she allegedly scammed people for rent money, claiming that she was getting evicted, and was going to uproot her family and move to South Dakota, I believe. And then, conspicuously, all traces of that disappeared, and she just kind of swept it under the rug with a thing about, well, we decided not to move, we're going to stay here and try to make the best of it, I guess. So, yeah. Allegedly, she scammed some people. Allegedly. I want to also... We'll also read a thing here from Kiwi Farms user by the name of DogProm3D, which says, and this is regarding the child abuse stuff that we saw before. Look, you're lucky if your parent didn't lose it at least a couple of times when you were a kid or a mouthy teenager. People are flawed, and even good parents can have really bad moments, and most of the time when they calm down, they're appalled and apologize to the child, and the kid grows up knowing it was loved and valued, and that any deviation from kind and concerned parenting was an aberration. But there is so deep a chasm between a harried mom in some form of active stress, cram-packed supermarket at the holidays while fighting a cold and worried she won't make it to pick up another kid on time, swatting a kid on the butt to get the kid's attention so that they stop whatever horribly annoying thing that they're doing, and a fat fuck leisurely making a saccharine video in her own home, hearing her distressed daughter bellow for her attention, getting up, calmly averting the camera, striking that screaming child, shutting the door, and resuming her fake sweet video. I can't wait to see if all the fat asses, Muslim LARPers, and bikini troons. Keep in mind, this is somebody else's post. These aren't my words. Just try to justify this as just one of those times a parent acts without thinking and regrets it. Wait for Fat Amy to tell us we don't know. We didn't know what the tiny child did to deserve a blow from a 500-pound monster, or how long Fat Amy cuddled her after. So that's, again, that's a post from DogProm3D that I felt was worth sharing. Not a bully stream, but I mean that's what DogProm has to say. So I felt like that was worth sharing. So how about that emotional support skunk, ladies and gentlemen? You guys remember when I mentioned she has an emotional support skunk? Time to get into this, I guess. Look, everybody, I've got children. Is this fucking video? Oh, God, is this music gonna goddamn get me copyright claimed? I swear to fucking Christ, lady. I swear to Christ. Oh, I swear to Christ.
Hey, you guys.
Hello.
Yes, we have a little boy. His name is Sebastian. He is 6 weeks old. He was born...
This poor... Guys, what do you think this guy... What do you think's going on in this guy's head right now? Oh, Kate Winslet is here. Hello, we might watch a couple of your clips in a little bit. I understand you chronicle this person. That's an admirable feat considering the little bit of content of hers that I've watched so far. Jesus Christ. Not a bully stream though. But yeah, consider what must be going through this man's head right now. Again, there's some halal jokes to be made right now, but I'm going to refrain from that because, you know, we're not bullying anybody.
Born May 12th, he is a skunk, as you all can see.
Yes, I can see that he's a skunk, a wild animal that can't easily be tamed or naturalized and made into a pet, like a dog or a cat. I see an animal who could very easily scratch out one of your children's eyes if you're not paying attention to them, which, let's be fucking honest here,
you're not going to be paying attention to them. So yes, I do indeed see the skunk, Amy.
We decided as that. A family that this would be an amazing an amazing addition to our family, and he is going to be my emotional support animal, and I could not be more happier. My husband surprised me with getting him, and you know, it's something I've always dreamed about getting, but I never thought my husband would actually go through with it and let me get it. And he came home one day and was like, why don't we get a skunk for you? And I'm like,
well, you know, it's not the most disgusting smelly thing in the house. Not a bully stream.
Oh my God. And so
definitely not a bully stream.
Very hard to get. We had to get permits and things like that. And so it was definitely something we worked towards.
Save baby.
And you know, when we decided to get something like this, this is obviously a life.
Kids are safer with the skunk than with her. You might be right.
Not going to last forever. But he is such a sweetheart. We just picked him up from the airport today. He came in from Iowa, and
this guy looks like the lawyer from The Wire. That's a deep cut.
And I cannot wait to continue to share his journey with everybody and let you guys see.
His husband's given the skunk more affection than he's ever given her.
He, oops,
let me tell you.
Did he just jump?
No.
Or he fall? He's like, I'm out of here. See you later, everybody. I just wanted to make a disclaimer, though, that...
Look at that.
Yes, she legally adopted the skunk, but not the child. That's correct. Good, good notice.
Hi, my
good,
name's Sebastian.
I'm the chat. King of YouTube. I don't know. King of YouTube.
Look at his little feet.
Hi, baby.
It's this sort of underlying, like, undercurrent of, you know, it's pretty clear that she wants to be, like, famous. She wants, like, YouTube fame, which I guess, I mean, is fair. If you're starting a YouTube channel, you want to get subs and such. But, you know, I don't know. With her, it feels like she brought a fucking crazy wild animal into her house. Because it's, like, kitschy and different. And it gets her attention, you know?
You want to come back.
Do you think, by the way, that people in, like, Egypt would be cool with these colored nails right now? Do you think that would be okay with them? Do you think her having a car where she drives around with a toilet in the backseat would be okay with people in Egypt? I don't know, Chad.
Okay. I just want to put a disclaimer out there because...
Not trying to get political, but what the fuck are skunks?
I've seen quite a few comments of people saying that we were doing clickbait, and if we were playing around with the fact of pregnancy, that that's not okay, that's not cool. Go ahead.
Well, first of all, if you're watching the channel, so you should know that it's not... We're not pregnant, okay? We just have been dealing with X-rays and a lot
she
of
she is just very large
stuff.
You should be know
how
that
it could happen. So if you're smart on watching the channel, that wouldn't come into your head. And there was a lot of people said it's an animal, and they were right on. Okay, and yes, it is a new addition to the family, and it's an animal. It's a baby skunk. So, and
for anybody that knows us through YouTube would know that that's not something we would ever play with is pregnancy,
yeah.
Especially being that we have dealt with a loss ourselves. We would never use that as a clickbait status. But yesterday's video was simply saying, what is it?
I mean, she's using the skunk as a clickbait status. And as we know that she seems to value the skunk more than the child, considering she had legally adopted the skunk. And not the child. So
gonna be a boy or girl. We never said
she
anything
uses the
about
kids
it being
as
a pregnancy,
bait.
A baby. I have not talked about anything about me being
Man,
pregnant.
The fucking porn bots are working
so
overtime.
For anybody
tonight,
that good, felt that way, I am
good, good
sorry
job, Zach,
if that's the way that you guys took it. It definitely was not our intention. We wanted to make it something fun because this is exciting.
Ignore
for
your
us.
Kids, ignore
and,
your wife.
You know, this is something that we have looked so forward to that we wanted to make it very special for us and for you guys, and that's exactly what we plan to do. And so again, I apologize. Ollie apologizes if you guys took it the wrong way. We hope that you guys understand the fun of it, because it's a very exciting time for us, and we don't want to ruin the excitement. Our kids are so excited and ecstatic to have a new baby in the house.
Oh, well, I'm sure they are.
And so I will be sharing with you guys all the journey of having him. He's going to be in most all my videos. We will be taking him out because he can go on a leash with us. We will be training him and everything.
By the way, brief reminder that Neverlander sucks.
Thing. And so I just wanted to make sure that you guys know that this is all about Sebastian and the joining of our family, and I hope you guys stay tuned for all the excitement to come with him and his story. And I will be showing clippets here, the excitement that we were having coming up to the airport to be able to get our baby. So take care, you guys. I hope you enjoyed the video.
So she got the... Wait, why is the video, like, not over yet? What the fuck? What's all this?
I just wanted to show you guys, and we'll get lots more videos of him.
Great. Wow, her face is very hairy. Okay, so that's... I'm so happy I could cry. let's see, what else do we got here? What else is next on the revolving carousel of garbage? Oh, yes! I mentioned before she neglected her kid for Christmas. I kind of forgot about that. We moved into the skunk. But let's move on to this one. Very emotional vlog. Guys, this is emotional. So this is another 30-minute one. We're probably not going to do the whole thing, but we're going to watch some of it at least. By the way, get a load of some of these other ones here. How a morbidly obese takes a shower. A morbidly obese. She's one single morbidly obese. Also, how to find love at KFC. Yes, very good. I would expect nothing less. Sasuga ya!
Good morning! Welcome to Thursday! Yes, I can't believe we're already almost through another week. Like, where is this month gone? Because we're clearly almost already at the end. Anyways, good news, you guys. I got my Etsy shop up and running. It is open. So I will put the name of it right here on the screen. It is called Vinyl Nut Design, not Designs. So there is a shop out there called Vinyl Nut Designs that is under me. But that's because I kind of forgot to write all my information down, and I completely locked myself out of it, and I could not figure it out. You guys, I have worked on this for over, I ain't even going to say, hours, but I finally got it up.
Yeah, the running. Kids are always crying. They're always screaming.
So as you guys make purchases, I'm just so excited. So anyways, we had to stop and go look for something really quick when we couldn't find it. Anyways, but I just wanted to check in with you guys and say an official good morning. We are on our way. We have to go to Michael's because I need to take back one of my vinyls and get something different. And I don't know what else we got to do, but I just wanted to share with you guys the good news about my shop being open.
Oh, like shit, I said, guys, F's in chat, Boogie died.
The screen so you guys can see that it is a Vinyl Nut Design. Make sure it does not have an S at the end of it.
Vinyl Nut!
I am going to be working all day on getting my inventory up and on the shop so you guys can start getting orders in.
Shut up. When do you get into the story? Come on. Let's get to the emotional. I nearly died. Or whatever. I nearly cried. Nearly died crying. And something.
651. They're both Oracle 651, which I think is permanent. I think. So I got a turquoise color and a pink color. And then I got my shelf over there completely organized, got all the boxes labeled with everything on them that I'm gonna need. I got my dresser cleaned off to the
okay, come on.
Anyways,
Jesus Christ,
what else?
It's amazing when people like edit their videos and they still keep in all this fucking dumb shit that nobody cares about.
I think that was it. I mean, I honestly just it took me a while to get everything because I had to break everything down from the shelving put that all away in the closets, and then pull up the boxes, which I just, I'm absolutely in love. These are the ones that I got from Dollar Tree. So I got big ones down on the bottom, medium ones, small ones, and then down on the very bottom I have another two, which are adult t-shirts and plus size t-shirts.
Someone in chat points out, and I like this message, she doesn't even acknowledge her kids. Like, at least include your kids on camera, maybe shift it to them and say something like, say good morning you guys. Yes, something like that. You're right, chat member. Something like that, that just sort of, you know, includes them and part of the process. But she seems like very narcissistic, and like it's really all about her. So that's, you know, it's very evident as you watch her videos. It's very focused on just her narrative. You know, it's like she's the protagonist in this story, and the kids are just the NPCs that she has spawned. Something like that.
And then as my inventory comes in, then I'll just fold them all, put them in there.
Maybe I'm wrong. By the way, Zach, okay, eventually you're going to ban someone there who's like labeled, so actually, you know, not a porn bot.
Come up with, then I could put it all away. Oh,
good editing. Great editing.
Anyways, other than that,
if only my editing was like this, I could get more videos done.
Worked for a very long time getting all of my inventory up on my Etsy shop, so that is available now. And again, I think I already said that I was gonna put the name in on, so I will definitely do that.
What is with this editing?
And yeah, it's just been one of those days.
Well, don't worry. I'm sure this will get archived. I'm sure I'll get community striked. Is it striked or struck?
Funk days.
I think it's actually striked in this case. Anyways, when does she start, like, admitting to the weird shit? When does it get emotional? Oh, she's crying. She's got the tears happening.
December is, like, my toughest time.
Oh, no.
And sometimes this is when I feel the most loneliness, and this is when
loneliness,
I feel like I push people away, and I know I have been lately.
Well, I mean, you did smack your child when she was screaming for your help.
December represents,
that's not good.
Me being pushed away from
you
people.
You probably pushed her away a little bit when you did that.
Things like that. So
don't you think you would adjust the hijab to hide the double chin?
Turn, I do it before somebody can do it, even though the people that are in my life are not gonna push me away. But it's like a mental thing that I feel like I have to push everybody away during December because I'm afraid who's going to do it. And just December is a really hard time for me. And, you know, December 24th, 2009, I'll never forget. I had no inquiries of even feeling
pregnant.
By the
way, guys, my neighbor with the fucking truck is out there again.
And I remember that day so real. Like, it's just like it happened yesterday. I remember I was at my cousin's house because I was staying with her at the time. And this is right after I got home from Egypt. Within like 2 weeks, because I got home, I think it was like the 10th or something. Yeah, I think the 10th of December. And I remember the 24th, because it was Christmas Eve. And again, you know, Christmas holidays, they suck. You know, I came home from Egypt and I had no money because I had spent all my money on my trip. Mm-hmm. That I didn't get to really buy my son any gifts.
In other words, she went to Egypt. She spent all her money on herself and her boy toy gallivanting around the pyramids. And then she came back and she wasn't able to buy a soccer ball for her tiny children. That's really breaks your heart, doesn't it?
I felt so guilty. I felt so bad because I was such a bad mom. Because, you know, I was selfish and took a trip to Egypt and I wasn't able to really give my son the Christmas I wanted to give him that year.
you didn't really want to give him that good of a Christmas if you chose to abandon your son in America while you went off and fucked off in fucking Egypt. You had the ability not to do that, but you chose to do that. So I don't know, you seem to have not cared that much about his Christmas before that. Also, aren't you Muslim? Why would you care about Christmas?
Because at that time I was celebrating Christmas. Like, not really celebrating it, but I would still try and do something nice for Jeremiah. So anyways, I remember I was like, you know what, I have a pregnancy test that I had taken, or I had a pregnancy test that I had bought. And I remember going in the bathroom, I was going to take a shower. So I was like, well, I'm just going to take it. Just, it's in the closet or in the cupboard and it's mine, so I might as well just take it.
Addicted so to I Muslim, did, but not celebrating
and it. I remember putting it up on top of the shower ledge.
Zach, you're
I'm finishing
banned.
My shower, and I was like, I was praying while I was taking a shower, and I was like, God, the best Christmas gift you could ever.
Which God were you praying to? Did you remember that you were Muslim that day? Or
give me, since Christmas has always been such a painful time for me.
I mean, I don't mean to imply that this is just a total fucking fad thing that she's clinging to because she wants to be a special snowflake on the internet. I definitely wouldn't want to imply that, but well, I guess it also has to do with trying to lure in a guy who wanted a green card and now can't leave because he's going to pay fucking, you know, $10,000 alimony every month now that there's like 7 or 8 children. That's right. Fuck the stupid fucking truck.
And I remember looking at and the pregnancy test and it being positive.
Thank God, guys, she had another child. She had a positive pregnancy test after she fucking neglected one of her children already. She had another child she can neglect now. Isn't that so emotional? Guys, this is so emotional right now. Alexa, play Despacito.
And I remember looking at the test and being like, oh my God, you answered my prayers. You gave me a baby.
Someone came in me and baby is formed. It's a miracle. Yes, chat member. It's almost like that's the way it's worked for 10,000 years. Maybe he was doing her in the wrong hole. I mean, that's always fair too, but...
I remember walking around with that test all day long, like literally in my hand. I kept looking at it. I was like, oh my God, I'm pregnant. Oh my God, I'm pregnant. And, you know, and it was Christmas Eve. So, oh my God, it's Christmas. I'm pregnant, you know, and I'm so excited. I get to have this baby that I've always wanted. And
she gets a baby, guys. Isn't that great? She already has one child that she can't provide for, or, you know. I love how she just segued directly from, I felt like a bad mom who couldn't provide for my kid, and I was selfish fucking off in Egypt with my husband. She segued directly from that to, and now I have another baby! Isn't that great, guys?
I'm so sorry, you guys, but this is just my...
You're welcome, Alexa owners.
This is my reality.
Xbox, turn off.
Every place, every year... And I don't know if I'll ever get over it, you know, as much as I want to. I don't know if I ever will. Because it's very painful. And taking that December is already a bad year or bad month for me out of the year. To have December 24th find out the day that I was pregnant. After asking God so deep in my heart to give that baby to me.
Don't you mean Allah?
To just 4.5 short months later to lose him. Makes the 24th of December one of the most saddest days of my life.
Aww.
Well, it is always sad when a miscarriage happens. I assume that's probably what happened there. That is pretty sad, but I mean, you've already got the one kid that you clearly aren't that great at taking care of, you know? You might want to just, like, kind of hone your skills on that kid. Call him the test kid. He's adopted. He doesn't count. But call him the test kid, and then when you have your real kid, you know, you can practice what you've learned, you know, with the test kid. Exactly, it's the practice child.
I apologize, you guys, that the last few vlogs have been just kind of short and sweet, to the point, and not my normal self, and not the normal, like, happy Amy that I want to be.
Yes, somebody in chat says miscarriages are sad, but would she be happy with another child? Definitely wouldn't want to say that she should have miscarried, that's a good idea. That's not something you want to say. I wouldn't agree with that either, but I would say that, you know, I think she has three kids now and a fourth kid. I mean, she's not very good at handling the three that she's got now, so I don't know if she needs a fourth one, you know what I mean? Definitely. I feel like if she had one biologically at this point, she probably wouldn't have adopted another kid. I'm assuming the other ones were adopted, but yeah, you know, I mean, if she wound up with four, that would have been a problem. One is a problem.
But I carry a lot of pain in December for multiple reasons.
Somebody in chat asks who she's apologizing to. Oh, this is a good still. Somebody asks who she's apologizing to. Does anybody really care if she doesn't post? I think she... it's not so much that people care if she doesn't post. It's more that she wants people to know that she's going through a very emotional time in this very emotional vlog, guys.
And I haven't dealt with it all just yet. And I hope and pray one day I can get through December and it be a month that I can look at and be like, okay, you know what? It's an okay month. Yeah, unfortunately, things happened during December that didn't happen in other parts of the year. But at the same time, until I can get over all of that pain, it resembles a bad time of the year for me. And I know I'm not the only one. I think everybody has time in their life during the year that could be harder than others.
Okay, well, she had a miscarriage. That sucks. That's definitely not something that I'd wish on anybody. That's unfortunate. It's very unfortunate. No question about that. But I don't think that, I mean, she's still not a very good mother. I'm gonna just say that, in my opinion, at least. I don't believe that she's a very good mother. And for her to have another kid probably would have been a bad thing for that child overall. Just as being exposed to her now seems to be not the greatest of things for those children. But, you know, that's just my opinion. Definitely not making any accusations or trying to bully anybody. But, you know, let's move along here. Let's move on. Now, these are the videos that I have curated for the stream, and we've got some more stuff coming that I don't know anything about. I've got some stuff that I've saved, but I've also got some stuff that I haven't saved that she's just posted that we're just going to go through her channel and we're going to be like, hey, this one looks interesting. So we've got a ways to go here, chat, at least until we get fucking copyright struck. So this one here, what is this one? Oh yes, this is where we need to apologize to her for saying that she is abusing her children.
Hey,
why is there a big Chungus meme in the thumbnail for this one? Oh god, okay.
Everybody, welcome back to my channel, and if you're new, welcome to. If you haven't already done so, would you ever so kindly hit the notification bell and also the subscribe button, and that way you get notified every time when I upload and also when I go live. I just want to give a little thank you to all of my subs and my viewers for all of your guys' support.
Unless you're one of them dang haters.
And I haven't said it enough that I appreciate all of your guys'. thumbs up your guys' support on the side chats, all of your guys' encouragement, your emails, all of your guys' time that you have taken out to check on me. I appreciate it so much. And I honestly feel very, very special to have God such a special
Zach,
people
you
on
stole
my channel.
That one right out from under me.
I just want to apologize to everybody right now for the way that
this
my channel has been kind of
stream.
Running the last couple of months. I apologize that it has been kind of a negative channel lately, and I don't know where it went wrong that it took a left field, but I have been
your
in that space
guises.
Where I feel like I have to continuously justify myself and to prove myself that I'm not this person that people are putting
you know
me
what,
out to be.
You know what sucks is watching these videos. You know what would make it a little better? Some music. Hang on.
On other channels. And I need to realize that I don't need to justify myself to you guys, because you guys, as my true subs, you guys understand that, and you know who I am, and you guys have been here, and you've chosen to be here, and you want to be here. I can't control what they're doing, but what I can control is how much I allow it to affect me. And I have unfortunately let it affect me a little bit too much lately, and that's not okay. And I think it has allowed it to affect me enough to interfere with my weight loss. I think that it has even sent me into going backwards on,
it's not too loud, right?
On something that I have been battling.
Should make this a little bit more bearable.
For a very long time. And yesterday I found myself. Well,
by the way, yes, she's finally covered the double chin with the
job. In months. I want to say, actually, it's been almost probably a year that I have not binged. And yesterday, I found myself binging. And I am so...
The music makes this sound like pre-boss dialogue. You must apologize for your transgressions, dirty trolls. But now there is no time to pay me back in apologies.
Mad at myself.
Have at you!
So mad at myself that I allowed these situations and these words that are being said about me.
Oh, this makes this so much better.
To affect me so much that I allowed a binge.
She's gonna eat the world! We must stop her, Trevor Belmont!
I went to bed so down on myself, and thank God I had my counseling session today, so that helped me to get better, and you know, and helped me get into a better mind. And
why would you edit the video like that? What the fuck is wrong with you?
I was talking with my counselor today about it, and talking about like the events that have been going on lately that have probably contributed to why I binged yesterday. And
you know, I can get away with playing
you know,
whatever
I
want because she's
the only one that
gabbing over it, so it's fine. Hang on.
The binge.
Some good
nobody
shit in here.
Has the control over that. Nobody can make me binge, and nobody can not make me binge.
Well, she certainly can.
I am the
can.
Only one that can control that, and I take full accountability for that. Now, circumstances can cause it, but I have the choice to do it because I have tools in my tool belt.
You guys
want to
listen to some Beatles
binge,
while she's
but
talking?
Yesterday, I failed to use my tool belt.
You want
to
just turn this into a fair use copyright bonanza stream where we listen to, like, Led Zeppelin and shit, but and just cover it up with this lady talking about, like, eating? Wouldn't that
and
be great?
And I chose to go ahead and make a binge instead, and that really hurt me that I fell back into an old habit and binged. I also, last night, started getting blisters in my mouth. And I think that it's because of stress, and it's all around things that I am allowing to get to me, and that's not okay. I am not okay allowing negative things to come to me that much. So
I'm not okay allowing negative things to come to me, and that's why I religiously read my Kiwi Farms thread and delete videos when they pick up on the things that I'm doing that are wrong and make me look bad.
But I don't do that. I am
not going to address negative behavior from people.
Exactly.
I am not going to address or even answer back to negative comments. I'm done. You know, I want my channel to be a positive place, a positive platform. When people come, I want them to feel good. When they leave, I want them to feel even better. I don't want people to feel like they're coming in and being beat up.
I just wanted to leave, they feel worse, give the chat something good for a second.
Right now, I think that that's what's happening, and that's not okay. I am not okay with that.
So boss fight engaged.
Negative comments coming through, you're going to start getting blocked because you know what?
This lady is boring. Play okay. Blackbird by the Beatles. Fuck it. Okay.
I don't. To me, numbers don't mean anything if you're abusing people. You know
what's that? What's that? You want to go over that one again, there, Amy? Hang on. Let's rewind. Let's rewind that one, Mitch. All right, Bill.
It's not okay. You know, I don't. To me, numbers don't mean anything if you're abusing people. Yes, my channel is growing leaps and bounds. But also, it's not fair.
Play Spoon by Chibo Mato. That's a good suggestion. I only know the song Birthday Cake by them, which also works. I'll cue that
my
one up.
Growing leaps and
but yeah, yeah, you don't want to get a views if it has to do with abusing people. That would be bad. You wouldn't want to do that, would you, Amy? You definitely wouldn't want to do that. Let's give Amy the benefit of the doubt here and assume that she's just so... Again, not a bully stream, but again, we're giving her the benefit of the doubt and assuming that she is not abusing her children. As far as she knows, let's assume that what she thinks she's doing is punishing them or, like, giving them discipline or something like that. Let's assume that she at least has somewhat the right idea here. I don't know, man. It still doesn't make it okay what you're doing. You've got people telling you you're, like... You're kind of fucking up these kids and their lives. And you're still doing the things. And all you really do... I think today she shut down the comments on all her fucking videos, apparently. Because people keep calling her out for abusing her children. And screaming at her children and neglecting her children. And, yeah, I mean, she just decided to close the comments. Which is, the sign of somebody who's... taking people's criticism and learning from it, as we all know.
And people are being abused verbally by people.
Not that's a bully not on okay. stream.
You know, that live that I did the other day was so
unbelievable. State of this lady.
I really had a hard time putting it even back up because of the comments. And people made the... People are making the comment that I took the comments music. Down. You're right, I did. Because there were so many vile comments made on that.
Vile live. Comments.
I did not want anybody to reread those comments.
Almost as vile as beating your child because they're screaming for your assistance.
That is why I disabled those comments, and I will keep them disabled because there were comments made in there that just were not okay, that my mods couldn't even keep up because there were so many comments flying through. That were just straight nasty, and I'm not okay with that. So if you're gonna come to my channel, I hope you have the intentions that you're coming for support and you're coming to also, you know, encourage one another, because we were always a community of each other. You know, we always encouraged each other, and that's what we have always been. All of a sudden, Rotten Lemon came in and it has...
Sasha, how dare you?
Everybody, and that's just not okay.
I'm appalled, Sasha. You fucker.
I'm not giving up on myself with my health. It's not worth it. I know that I need to get my health in check. And that is why, even though I had...
This isn't the Garden State soundtrack. This is fucking Simple Things by 07. Don't you bring Zach Braff into this.
Going to allow myself
Let's
to
sully this good album with Zach
Braff. Because normally, if I had a binge, I would have just.
By the way, this is officially just a low key music stream now.
That, oh, chill out, it. Everybody. Okay, I binge so
chill much. Out to the sounds of nice music being obfuscated by this lady's terrible, terrible life decisions.
You know, let the whole thing go out the door. No, I binged. I did what I did, and
so basically, what we're getting from this is that we're all saying horrible things, and we need to apologize, because we're saying, when was this posted? Oh, very recently. Okay, this was posted within a few days of people saying that she abuses her kids because of that video where we hear her abusing her kids. Yeah. So, yeah, we all need to apologize, everybody.
Today I woke up and I was like, nope, you're going to get up. You're going to do what you need to do. You're going to exercise. You're not going to sit and do this.
Stream is like listening to music in the car while your friend rants about their stupid life problems. I like that. I'm trying to listen to 07, you fucker.
To yourself. So I didn't.
I don't care about your shit.
You know, for me.
Edit your videos better.
Have a vision that I have seen above in front of me, and that vision is what I keep my eyes on. That vision is me standing there,
child abuse,
thin and healthy and happy and energetic, and being able to have a fun life with my family. I see myself in such a different world. And I want that. And that's what I see in front of me. That's my goal. That's what I'm walking towards. And yes, I'm going to have hiccups along the way. I'm going to have days where what happened yesterday happens, because I'm dealing with certain things as well as I'm trying to get to my goal. I'm also battling other things. But I can't let those other things come in between me and my goal and take me out like I have allowed it to do every other time. And that is why when I binged a lot yesterday, when I went
to... So basically she's trying to, like, excuse the reason why she... Doesn't she have, like, an ongoing weight loss journey thing where she went, like... She lost, like, 15 pounds 1 week, and then the next, like, 3 weeks, she gained, like, a few more pounds, and then 1 week, she gained, like, 20 pounds in 1 week? Am I wrong? Did that not happen? I feel like I heard something about that. She's got like an Amber Lynn-esque weight loss journey that seems to be trending up. Maybe I'm wrong about that one. How do you do that?
To bed last night, I made a promise to myself. When you get up, Amy, tomorrow's a new day. You can't stop. You gotta keep going. And that's exactly what I did. I got up, I went to counseling, came home, I made my eggs and my toast, I'm drinking my water.
I made sure to fill my gob before I did anything else.
And I already took my vitamins, and I'm feeling great, you know, and I'm not even binging.
A new day to spoon them kids, yes.
Today's a new day.
Yes, she drinks water, chat.
I have to remind myself every day is a new day, and every day is going to come with its own own problems. And
hey, shut up, kid. I'm trying to listen to the song. Oh, wait. Now I'm like her. Oh, God. I'd be a bad parent, too.
And it's just how I deal with them.
By the way, this is just not a bully stream opinion, but this is an opinion. I don't like her laugh very much. Not a big fan of her laugh.
But I just wanted to say thank you to everybody, because you guys have all been very amazing. And another thing too is, if you feel like you want to make a comment but you're not really wanting to make a comment on my channel just right now, you can always email me. My email is always in the description below. You can email me and I will.
Guys, we can always email her. I don't want to suggest that anybody do that, because that would be bad, and we definitely, legitimately don't want to brigade people, because that's a stupid idea, but, yeah, you don't want to do that. I'm not sure why, if you're getting trolled, you'd put your email in the description of your videos, but okay, that's fine.
We'll get right back to you as soon as I can get back.
Man, I love this album.
I usually get back within a day or two, usually.
Can I get away with turning the music up a little bit?
Doing it that way for right now, I'm totally cool with that. But anyways, anything else that is resulting towards drama channels or comments being made about me, I am not going to address those things anymore. I don't care. I really don't care.
She's not going to address those things anymore, guys. So that means she doesn't care. which is why she's definitely not going to community strike me. I'm kind of aware that she probably will. In fact, I'm surprised that that's not happened while I've been streaming so far. I gotta say, yeah, no, I mean, I think she probably will. I feel like it's not gonna be too much of a problem for me, because I think they give you, like, a warning first now. But even if it is, I mean, I don't know, man, I'm talking about a lady who beats her kids with a spoon. I feel like I'm allowed to make one or two jokes. Aren't we allowed to make a joke? You know, I don't harbor any ill will to this person because of her opinions or her religion or her any of her beliefs. I harbor some ill will, though, because she fucking beats her kids, apparently, and she's kind of not a very good mother. And she apparently scams people and does a lot of other shit that's not so savory. But you know what? Can't we make, like, a couple of lighthearted jokes, man? I don't know. Are we just not allowed that anymore? This feels like such a fucking 1984 society that we live in now, man. Bottom text.
It has nothing to do with me. Those videos, you know, the thing is those videos are being made for the person that's actually making the video. And when I say that is because people that make videos about other people is because
I promise I'm not drunk yet.
The person that's making the video might be feeling pretty bad about themselves. So
music and minor somebody. Beating.
So they choose a low person to drag so that they could feel just a little bit better about themselves, and that's okay. There are people out there that are low in, you know, self-esteem, and they need something to pick them up.
She's trying. Somebody in the chat asks what she's going off about. I think she's going off on the same thing that, like, oh god, this is embarrassing. The Ghostbusters 2016 movie tried to do. You know what I mean? Where it's like, oh, they're all just losers. They're all just sad, pathetic trolls. They just need something to make them feel better. And it's true that probably a lot of people watching this right now as we speak are watching this in an attempt to make their own lives feel a little less shitty. Make them feel a little better about their own terrible decisions. But, but I mean, you know, exposing somebody's, like, misdoings. Like, I don't know. I feel like with people like her, and it's kind of like with Onision, too. I was thinking about him earlier. I don't know how many of you follow him when you're not watching my streams about him, but if you don't know, he's decided to change his format a little bit. He's retired his face, and he's now doing, like, some kind of weird, disgusting 3D model thing. And also doing videos with, like, his hands instead of his face. And it's really awkward, and it's like, I stopped for a second today. I was putting on my pants at the time. I don't know why that was vital to tell you, but it's the truth. I'm the fax machine. God damn it. And I was putting on my pants at the time, and I was like, you know something, man? Onision, does he even, like, know the kind of trouble that he's in with the claims people have made about him? He's making all these stupid fucking videos with this stupid model and, like, his hands, and it's like, does he even recognize the actual trouble he's in? And I feel like Amy is in a similar boat where, like, I don't know if she realizes that I get it to an extent because it's easy to get lost in the fact that she is a larger woman who is a white lady who is apparently a Muslim. You know, it's easy to make some jokes about that. Those are the easy target jokes. But, like, you know, it's fair perhaps for her to even say, you know, the trolls that make comments about my weight and my blah, 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 like, they're whatever. And she can make comments about that. But the thing is that people are making a lot of comments about the actual actions that she's taking. It's not all directed at her looks and her appearance and her beliefs. It's directed most of it, at her actions and the way she treats people, the way she treats her kids. And, yeah, I mean, you can't really just do the whole thing where you're like, I don't care, dude. I don't care about the haters. I'm just gonna dab on the haters or whatever. I'm just gonna close the comments. You can't really do that when people are pointing out, like, the things that you've done that are, like, against the law and kind of fucked up morally. I don't know. Rant over. I just wanted to say, like, this is another one of those people where I don't know if she fully understands the ramifications of the things that she's being, like, accused of. and being... I'm not the one accusing. I'm not making any accusations. I'm just reporting what I've seen. But I don't think she totally understands the gravity of the situation. You know what I mean?
That's all right. They want to be in the, you know, the cloud with everybody else in the circle or whatever. You know, go for it. But I'm not going to address it no more. I am not going to address people taking my videos and picking them apart. I have nothing to hide. What I have put out, I have put out. What maybe I put to sleep, I might have put to sleep on my channel. I am not going back and putting any of my channel to sleep, my videos. I did say on my live...
She's not putting her videos to sleep? Okay.
Put all my channels to sleep that had to do with my
to
kids.
To sleep.
I'm not going to do that because that was a time in my YouTube life that I did have. And I don't think that it's really necessary, but I am not putting them on camera now. But they, you know, were on camera in the past. And, you know, I already know people have videos of all of those. So
someone in chat says, has her hitting her kids actually been shown on YouTube? There was a video that we saw earlier where she went out of her way not to show it. The camera was not propped up to show it. But it was heard. The exact sequence of events, I believe, was the kid was screaming in the background while she was doing her video, and she went and she put the camera down, and we heard her open the door, get on the floor and do the dinosaur. No, we heard her open the door, we heard her smack the child began to scream, and then the mom began to go like, "No, ma'am, you don't scream like that! Get out! Go out!" or something. So we have technically not seen her, not actually, well, actually, I don't know. There are some videos people mentioned. I don't know if I saved them, but there was one that she mentioned where, or there was one that Kiwi Farms Post mentioned about somebody hitting one of the kids. It was either like the dad or it was one of the kids. I don't know, but there's some shit going on, basically. And I don't know, guys. I don't know.
I don't even bother at this point. But I'm not going to be...
Even over and above the abuse stuff that people are talking about, there's this clear level of just... The kids are more like props than anything.
Videos of my videos and making commentary on them. It really... It's not going to affect me any.
Okay, it's not going to affect her any if we point out the things that she's doing that are actually against the law, like owning a child. Like owning a child who she did not actually adopt or in any way acquire legally. She just was given this child. She was just granted this child like an item at the end of a Yakuza side quest.
Again, like I said, I have nothing to hide. I don't need to justify myself at all. At all. I don't need to prove myself. My words are enough. Just like I said yesterday, my words are enough. I say what I say, and that is it. You can either accept it or you don't have to. If you don't, that is not my problem. That is your problem. My problem is to say what I say and leave it at that.
Who the fuck is mad that I'm talking too loud into the mic? Do you want me to scream, fucker? Is that what you want?
If you don't accept it, sorry. But that's as much as I can do. So, now, we're gonna get...
Alright, this video's boring. Anyways, we all need to apologize for being mean to her because she, like, slaps her kids on camera. We all need to apologize, chat. So... What's next on the docket? What's next? I think we... Okay. We've got this one. We've got this video called Cooter Stank Like Fish. I want to just rephrase that, chat. This video is called Cooter Stank Like Fish. Let me just take a look at the chat real quick. Why are you people saying that I'm like screaming? I'm talking at a perfectly normal volume. What is wrong with you people? Okay, thanks for the copyright claim, fucker.
Went to bed last night and I kind of was like stuffed up a little bit. I was like, there's no way I'm coming down with like a summertime cold our springtime cold? Well, I don't know if I am or not, but I woke up this morning just kind of stuffed up and like a little bit congested in my lungs. So, it best stay away. I don't have time to be sick. That is like one extra thing that we don't need to add to the bucket. Anyways, I hope everybody had a wonderful weekend.
Is she out of breath from driving?
This weekend was a really good weekend. I got a lot accomplished that I've needed to get done. And that is a great feeling because the last few weekends, I just feel like I've been in such a slump and it's not a good feeling to have. And so when you can kick yourself out of it,
What is written on the back of her van? I believe it says Amy's Life Journey, because I think that's the name of, yes, that's the name of her channel, Amy's Life Journey. So again, by the way, chat, again, this video is called Cooter Stank Like Fish. I feel like you need to know that. I'm sorry. Going forward, you need to know that.
Yourself for the weekend, it's a good feeling. And so, yes, I can honestly say I stayed focused.
Do I put DeadwingDork in the back of my car? I actually wave a flag everywhere with my bear picture on it.
I love them.
That's how I get the subs.
Pretty. I love them. Anyways.
Those nails are... Those pretty nails are just so pretty. I'm sure your husband loves seeing you drive a car with those nails looking the way they are. Well, again, I'm not meaning to make any jokes here, because making jokes is against YouTube's guidelines now. But as far as being committed to the Muslim faith goes, I don't know. I feel like I feel like the nails might be. I don't know about that one.
Anyways.
I don't know about that one.
I went and got my nails done, which was nice because it was a little bit of time down for myself. And then I got some cups done that I've had orders for that needed to get done. So I got those, put on two more last night. So they're in the first, their first coat of resin. Now I've got to do a little bit more to it. But yeah,
sounds
I
had Sonic Adventure music. What?
But I did want
somebody tell Steven Wilson that his music sounds like Sonic Adventure music.
Right,
apparently.
Up to date on my IUD because I haven't talked about that for the last few days. I decided to go ahead and go with having surgery and having it removed and another one put in, but under anesthesia. At the hospital, because I just don't think that I want to, of course, go through the process.
Beating your kids at the speed of sound.
I feel like I have a good high tolerance of pain, but that taught me something different. Maybe I don't, because I was in a lot of pain during that procedure. Now, afterwards, I was fine. Now, I had my cycle last Monday.
Mm-hmm.
I stopped Thursday.
When do we get to Thursday? The cooter stinking like fish?
Thursday I stopped, but I've been spotting ever since then, which is very normal. They said that's nothing to be like alarmed with or anything like that. However, last night I was on Facebook and I don't know what group I'm in. Lady, slow down, please. I really don't need you to visit my back bumper.
Oh, now this woman just made me hate her.
I don't know what group it was in, but there was a lady that had posted that she's going to be getting the Mirena, which is what I have, and she was just wondering, like, people's take on it, you know, like, did you have a good experience, bad experience, you know, anything in between, because she's going to be getting it, and she was just curious.
Yeah, it's a bit of a clickbait title, but she just keeps going off about her period. Is this necessary?
So I started reading everybody's comments, and I'm not kidding you, out of probably 150 comments, probably 90 of them talked about how the partner could feel it. Now, they couldn't feel the actual Mirena, but they could feel the strings that are attached to the Mirena.
What is with the music? We need it to get through. Shut up.
Because the strings are kind of, I guess, sharp. I don't know. I didn't feel the strings, so I have no idea what they are. So that was one of the things. I don't know why I'm yawning. I feel good. Anyways, so that was one thing that was a little concerning. And then another thing was, I'm gonna go, buddy. Another thing was, it moved out of place on a few people over time, and they ended up having to have it surgically removed because it got too far up, I guess, in the uterine wall area. And then a couple people had actually punctured their uterus. So I'm thinking, oh my God, I really don't know now what I want to do, because it's like, oh, and then one of the things that was, oh my God, I laughed so hard. There was a lady, she says,
I feel like more people are interested in Go West Judas by Flower Kings right now than they are in this woman talking. Okay, I'm willing to assume that this video is a clickbait title and the cooter didn't really stink like fish, but I feel like she really wanted us to click on the video because of that title. So let's find a different one here. Let's take a look at how to find love at KFC, everybody. This is an exciting journey into love and Chungus and the B-movie, apparently. Maybe I know I'm excited.
Thongs? I don't wear a thong. Maybe you do, but not me. I don't wear that butt floss.
Oh, God. Can you imagine that one, chat?
House and tore that old fell.
How dare she use the big Chungus? She's a boomer.
And welcome.
I know, fucking Chungus.
Wednesday, no.
Well, if you're gonna see it from Wednesday, it's Tuesday.
Okay, so welcome to Tuesday. tonight, I thought that I would do something a little bit different. So as most of you guys know, that yesterday I went to the doctor's and I was told I had a kidney and bladder infection.
Oh no.
Yeah, haven't felt the best today. So I've pretty much stayed laying low, drinking lots and lots and lots and lots of water, and just pumping everything through me, getting my medicines and all that good stuff.
Her husband reminds me of the dude who sells cars in GTA 5. Anything,
I thought, you know, this is the best time ever to learn about me and Ollie together.
Oh no.
So my sweet husband agreed to get questioned.
Yeah, no.
And he's gonna question me. Don't know if that's a good idea or not. Anyways.
Wait, so, is he actually a car salesman?
Gosh, look at this. I feel like, you know, I can just get cushiony.
Some people in chat, not in chat, but some people in the Kiwi Farms thread were suggesting that maybe the husband is gay. People are, like, fascinated by the husband, because some people have the opinion that he's basically trapped into this marriage now, where she's got, like, a billion fucking children shooting out of her every 5 seconds. And, you know, he would have to pay, like, a Brendan Fraser level of alimony every month. So some people think that he's just trapped. Other people think that she's, like, the beard and he's, like, secretly a gay man. I don't know. I would say, listen, it's 2020, dude. You can be gay without having to suffer being with this lady.
You know,
I don't know if that's the answer.
Anyways, so we are going to do a Q&A. Kind of thought that was a little bit something fun.
I know I'm gay now that I've been watching this lady for 2 hours.
Neither one of us have gone over any of these questions. I don't know. That would make everything
so much easier.
So we had no time to, practice our answers. So you guys are going to see the answers as first time as we're going to hear the answers for the first time. And then after that, then I think that we'll share a little bit about our meeting experience.
Yeah, I know.
I know that a lot of you guys have had questions. So
I don't want to hear about you meeting. I don't want to hear about him meeting you.
And,
KFC, Kentucky Fried Camels, and...
We did not meet a Kentucky Fried Camel.
Kentucky Fried Cats.
However, when Kentucky I was Fried in Egypt, Cuckolds. That's what I was told that I was eating. Because I was told, oh, let's go to KFC! I was like, oh, woohoo! Whoop, whoop! KFC in Egypt! Yeah, well, as I'm sitting there enjoying my meal, he decides to tell me, honey...
Imagine being so American that you cheer because there's a KFC in Egypt.
You know what KFC stands for in Egypt, right? I'm like... Kentucky Fried Chicken, like, hello.
Hello.
Like, no, honey.
No, it stands for Royale with cheese.
You all should have seen how fast I dropped my chin. Like, what? What's occurring in my mouth right now? No.
Rabies foam? Chicken.
But he had me going for quite
crows,
some time.
I don't know.
Crows? Yeah.
So he played on her racism.
Before I could.
Sick.
You never know those people.
That is nasty. The things my husband thinks about.
There is a guy also in my neighborhood back home. He makes like a food truck. And he makes liver and sausage and stuff. And I love that guy. You know, since that guy opened, you never see any cat or street cats or street dogs, you know?
What?
Let me know the location of that place so I stay far, far away whenever we go back.
Are we getting botch kebabs? Is that what's happening?
Oh, yes. So, yes, it was Kentucky Fried Chicken, y'all. But he thought he was smooth and he thought he was cool when he told me that it was camel. Because I believed him. Because, you know, we were just...
Because I'm literally just that white. Because I'm literally just that American.
Like, how a thigh...
I was standing next
to him. Oh, tell us about the thighs, dude. We know you love them thick.
That he was going to be cool and swift and try and get me up on a camel? Yeah, not happening. Ha! Not happening. No.
So, you guys told me, how come you go to Egypt without, you know, seeing the camel and riding the pyramids, you know, and enjoying, you know? It doesn't make any sense.
I see the camel and I seen the pyramids. Yeah, I did.
Somebody in chat says the husband seems nice, and you're kind of not wrong. The husband doesn't seem like the biggest prick in the world, but I don't know. I'm ignorant, you know? I'm ignorant to the way that things are in Egypt. You know what I mean? Like, this guy's from Egypt. And no shame. No shade to anybody. No shame to anybody who's from Egypt. I'm not meaning that that's a bad thing by any means, but, you know, there's some certain beliefs that are held by certain people in that area of the world, which might not be the best for especially children. So, you know, when the kids might be getting, like, slapped by their mom, I wonder if the father cares? I don't know. I'm not meaning to offend, because this isn't a bully stream. Or and this isn't even a joke either. This is just genuinely my ignorance. I've heard that there's some very conservative, old-fashioned views at play in certain situations there. Like, especially parenthood, where it's a lot of, like, you know, tough love kind of thing. I don't know. But I know some people on Kiwi Farms had the opinion that maybe the dad... Not the dad, but the husband, at least, might be turning something of a blind eye to the kids being hit by the mom, or even involved by it. I don't know, but, you know, it's up to you to decide.
Well, I wasn't
also, this fucking song is a banger.
Oh, I wasn't gonna ride one. Although, you know, although he thought he was gonna be cool and get me up on this small itty bitty little horse carriage that my butt took up the whole thing.
I should have got on.
And this thing was like rocking back and forth, and you guys should have seen me. I was like, whoa! Oh, I was making myself
That's
look like
experiencing.
A
fool. I miss those days we go after midnight and ride horses over there and get up there. It's just amazing.
Yeah, my husband loves horses.
The song is Monster Within by Flower Kings.
He, on the other hand, no.
Pretty cool song.
I'll look at him from far direction, but I'm not going to touch him. No. But he would. Number one. What gift that your spouse gave you came as the biggest surprise?
Well, when you told me that you're pregnant, that was a big
Yeah, that probably hits the darts pretty high there.
Yep.
Yeah. And how about the second time that I told you I was pregnant?
That was also a big surprise.
That one, you guys? Oh my gosh. Yeah. Let me tell you. So when I took that pregnancy test the second time around,
I did not believe it.
He was at work and I was cooking dinner and I was seeing an extra test and I thought, I'm just going to take it because it's sitting here. Why not? One from Omar.
Why are we effing? Is the stream destroyed?
My 4 month
old dead?
Bouncing in his little bouncer. Yeah, cute. Go take the test and I sit it back down on the counter and I go to work on my dinner. I decided to take a little check and it says pregnant. I'm like, oh my gosh. So.
Oh, Boogie's dead.
What
oh, okay.
I do? Because I need to get this guy. I've got to get this guy. So I had just gotten a Bluetooth earpiece, and it came in like this perfect size box that fit the test. So I put it in there and I wrapped it up, and he's like, why are you spending money? Why are you buying me gifts? Because this guy does not like gifts. Like, he does not like surprises.
Give me the cash.
So, yeah, he's always like, give me the money. Cash. Give me the money. Yeah. So
give me the cash.
I was like, honey, just open the gift. Just stop it. Just open it. So he, of course, opens it. And this guy over here says, oh, is this Omar's test?
That's what I thought. I swear.
He thought it was Omar's test.
Why
would
he still keeping the test that yeah. you took with Omar? No, it didn't even cross my mind that she's pregnant again.
No, I looked at him and I'm like, no, babe. We're having another baby.
No, babe, I just gained 25 pounds.
He was like, you're joking. I'm like, nope. It's a big old pregnant.
You're joking. You yeah. mean I really can't get away?
I told him his second child.
Oh, by the way, Chad, it's time for fucking Spock's beard.
A little under 16 weeks when we found out we were expecting another one. At the time, didn't know that it was a little Ezra, but yeah.
Yep.
Between you and your wife, who would you generally say is the money spender and who is the money saver? That is my question. Like, come on. I'm the money saver. I am the one that saves all the money. And this guy blows through money like water.
Do we believe that?
I'm always freaking out because he just spins and spins.
This is the woman who's going around. Well, I mean, just look at her. You know what I mean? I mean, not a bully stream, but let's be honest. If it was, she wouldn't watch this far into it anyways. But this is not a bully stream. All I'm saying is, if I had to choose one of the two of these to believe is blowing all the money on fucking Wendy's right now, I don't know. I think it would be her.
And I just never know where the money's going.
And the detective said that was a lie.
Yes, you guys, I am not a very good money keeper. I have access to the bank account, but so does he. So he will make sure to check because they'll be like a spending of like $14. He'll be like, where'd you go? I'll be like, I don't know, Dollar Tree. He'll be like, okay, next couple days, where'd you go? I don't know, Goodwill. I used to be really good. Now
he does never care. Was good with budgeting, but
I was good budgeting at one point when I was 10 years old and I only had quarters. God.
Yeah.
No, he's so funny. He's my funny Bonnie. if your wife.
She sounds like Chandler's fake laugh in that one episode of Friends.
Thing of yours, oh, God. To get rid of. What would she choose?
What?
What's the one thing I would get rid of? What'd you do? Fall asleep?
No, I'm thinking, but there's nothing.
I would get rid of this mess in the garage. My husband loves his tools and his buildings. Someone's going to call on us and be like, there's a problem with this couple. As his mess in the garage would be a long goner if I could, because he's a mess maker. He loves his messes. And your wife says, honey, they're playing our song. What song are they playing?
The song is called Afterthoughts by Spock's Beard. It's pretty good. I like it. So that's enough of this one. I thought this would be funnier than it was, but it turns out it's just her fucking babbling. So let's take a look at Amy's channel here real quick. In fact, actually, let's not take a look at Amy's channel. We don't need to look at Amy's channel. We need to look at fucking Amy Ramadan Kate Winslet. Because this is a channel, Kate Winslet, that I think does like edits of this woman's wonderful, wonderful, incredible videos. Let's watch a couple. Again, full credit to Kate Winslet here, who I'm sure is the real Kate Winslet. What do we got here? People ask, how can a person abuse a child? I ask, how can so many good people not do anything about it? It's gonna be okay, Amy. I'm here if you need to talk. I understand where you're coming from. Been there myself. Yeah, guys, Amy's just so good about dealing with kids' abuse, you know?
To like function or whatever it might be.
Well, this is what we saw before, I think, with the spoon.
I don't know what I'm gonna do. I told Ollie that I was thinking I might just go ahead and go through the withdrawal of caffeine. What, honey? What?
We can watch this again.
Huh?
Okay, so the kids, I didn't catch that before, but according to the subtitles here, the kid's going like, my stomach. So the kid's got a painful stomach. Something's going on with the kid. The kid doesn't feel good. And what's the mom gonna do?
Okay, hold on, okay?
Guys, a sedative won't settle her. It's all one big conspiracy.
Anyways.
Such a banger of a song.
Okay,
hang on, child. I will get to your stomach after I'm done recording my video, okay? I have to finish doing my video. That's what's important.
So I'm wondering if I might have to go through, like, the withdrawal headaches to get it back out of my system again. No. Okay, Omar, do I need to get the spoon?
Get the spoon! Get the fucking spoon!
Stop. I carry this.
Threaten that child!
Do I ever use it?
Threaten to beat that child with a wooden spoon! Yes! Nope. That's how you parent! That is called parenting!
Yeah! All they have to do is see me put my hand
in. Yep, all I do is threaten my kids to beat them with a wooden spoon if they ever talk back to me about how bad their stomach hurts or whatever dumb shit. I don't care. I'm recording a video. Fuck you, you little shits. I'm busy.
They're like,
"No, no, 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 no." My stomach hurts. Wah! Fuck off, tiny stupid children. Fucking losers.
Sure, Jan.
Sure, Jan. Okay. Tree branches work better? I mean, maybe. Amy reveals her weight loss, everybody! Oh, what is it with chicks named Amy? Okay, so that's from, again, that's from Kate Winslet, everybody's waifu. Let's take a look at another one. KF is bad. Mmm-kay. So this must be, oh, is this one, this one's fucking age-restricted. Hang on. Hang on, we gotta do some magic. Hold on, real quick. Popping this over. Popping this bad boy over. Let's take a look here. Got this one. There you go. No, not Xbox Game Bar. You fuck. You fucker. There you go. That's fine. So this is KF is bad. Mm-kay. Who is this fucker? Who is this scumbag streaming about this same woman I'm talking about right now? Fuck this guy. Somebody report him. Don't do that, please.
Yesterday, I got a strange email. And in this email, I was told that I needed to heed a warning.
What do you mean I sound drunk? Shut up.
And it was talking about this Kiwi Farms.
Yeah, everybody go and raid that Deadwing Dork guy's chat and call him an asshole.
And how people write things.
I'm sick of that guy fucking streaming while I'm streaming. That fucker.
You know, it's like, I don't know. It's kind of like a forum that you can go on and bash people, I guess, basically. So, anyways, so I was just like, okay, you know, they sent me the link. In the email, they sent me the link, so I clicked on it. And it took me to the Kiwi Farms thing, and I started reading it. And, you know, to be honest with you, I laugh. I legit
If you're laugh. If you're an attractive guys, woman, be sure to call me an asshole.
I don't know what it's called.
So okay. She legit laughed at all of the gifs that they made of her, everybody. That's, I'm sure like, that's what happened.
And all this stuff. I laughed my butt off. I almost pissed my God. Pants laughing so
Well,
hard.
And you lost at least 70 pounds.
Information on Kiwi Farms. They put my Not address out stream. There. They've put my phone number out there. My criminal record. But they made sure to pull that up and say that I have this huge criminal record, which the only criminal record that I have is a misdemeanor, which I've
Definitely
told you guys
doesn't
about.
Sound
the
mad.
The misdemeanor is a theft too.
Hey, why are you guys calling me an asshole? Who told you to do that? That's so rude.
Reading all of this, they've put pictures of Omar on there talking about how my son is raggedy and I...
Can I call you an asshole even if I'm an ugly woman?
Talking about hey, I mean, somebody has...
You know what? I have some weird tastes, so that's probably fine. As for her kids being raggedy... Yeah, there's pictures of her kids, like, wandering into the frame while she's recording. And they look like the fucking Jumanji. They look like Jungle Man. They look like fucking Oliver Queen before he went back to Starling City. So, I mean, you might want to at least get your fucking kids some haircuts at the very least. I don't know.
Followed me.
Something very
me.
Strange is coming fast our way.
With my children out with no socks and shoes on. And calling FBI, they're not going to do anything. They really aren't. First of all, people have tried to shut Kiwi Farms down for years, I guess. And they've never been successful.
Deadwing, do you like receding hairlines? Well, I hate myself, so that should answer the question.
Something to do with the form, they cannot get it shut down. The person that I am catching... that runs the forum for mine is under strawberry something.
Strawberry douche, my boy!
What she does is, and this is what's scary. She has so much time, you guys. So much time on her hands. Or she, I don't know what it is. Sits and watches my videos and timestamps everything in my video. She took a drink of her soda and let a burp out. She looked up at her mirror and she blinked 3 times. I'm like, oh my God, who's got enough time to sit on their phone, computer, whatever, and literally write down every step that I took? She farted at 6.23. I can guarantee you I never ripped butt on my camera. I would never do that. If you were to ever go in and just read it, just because...
Wow, okay, so I remember somebody in the Kiwi Farms thread was like, I would love to see her go off in 20-minute videos about how she totally didn't fart on camera like Amber Lynn did. Did Amber Lynn do that? Because I don't care about Amber Lynn, and apparently she did that. But that seems to be what this video is just her saying, like, hey, you're wrong, fuckers. I didn't fart. Shut up. Women don't fart, okay? Women don't even have bowels, all right? Women don't even have asses, okay?
For shits and giggles, excuse me, for giggles, okay? I have the link, I can send it to ya.
I just can't do it.
Look here, look, listen! Okay. That'll do it for that video. Do we want to just take a look at her channel? I mean, we've been, no, not Yakuza soundtrack, hang on. Oh, fucking hell. God damn it. Oh, no, okay. I opened it to the wrong thing. Hang on.
We need to return it to the other. There you go. That one. That's good. So, let's see. Do we need to get the spoon treated like a queen? Proof of life. Is Sebastian alive and well? Hey, guys, the emotional support skunk who's being forced to eat cheese and apparently lives under Amy's bed. Is the skunk doing okay? I don't know. Oh no. We've got some ISIS music happening.
Look here! Listen!
Oh my gosh, you guys. Welcome to Friday! Woo! Party in the house!
Woo. Oh boy. The remix. The vocoded remix. Once again, shout outs to your girl, Kate, or boy, I don't know. There's no women on the internet. Kate Winslet for making this shit.
Oh my gosh, today has been a fantastico day. let's see, what all have I done? I got all of my results back. Everything came back perfect in normal range, but my A1C is elevated, so now he put me to double in the morning and at night of my metformin. Oh, and he's gonna call in a finger pricker. Ting ting thing to check my blood. And then he also found a urinary tract infection.
Dude, Kate Winslet in chat. Bless up.
So I did want Papa to bless. Address the question of, is Sebastian alive and well? Yes. My little Sebastian is alive and well. I will place a little video clip right here.
Developing now. Skunk hostage forced to eat cheese. That's not even cheese. That's like a Kraft single. That's not cheese. That's literally just plastic. How dare you feed that to a skunk? What's wrong with you? That's not even good food for you to eat. Okay, well, that's fine. Let's take a look at her actual channel now. We have not given Amy Ramadan a fair shot, okay? We've been looking at the nasty cherry-picked videos from her evil internet trolls. We haven't been watching the videos from the horse's mouth. I mean, from the pig's mouth. I mean, from the horse's mouth. So, let's find a video here that looks interesting. Something that really catches our fancy. Maybe this will be the last one we do, because we've been going for a little while here. Let's find like a last one, like a good last one. Kiwi Farms, let's go. Exciting! This is hard. Problem is, she deletes a lot of her videos. So, I mean, a lot of the stuff that's like really incriminating is kind of no longer on her YouTube. But what if you were to just go to her YouTube, you heard about this woman, maybe you saw her in the sidebar or whatever, you look up her channel, and you click on her YouTube, and you go through her videos, and maybe you decide to watch one of these videos, I don't know. Which video would you decide to watch, chat? I love me some burgers, that sounds very halal. Why do I do this? New wedding ring. I got scammed. By the way, chat, if you've got any suggestions for a video to watch, the workout, or this idiot got stuck in an MRI. Where's the work? Oh, we gotta do the workout. You're right. Okay, hang on. Before we finish, we've got possibly a couple videos to watch. Firstly, let me sort by most popular. I want to see what the most popular workout video is. I want to see what we got here. Obese and pregnant. Can a morbidly obese girl have a safe pregnancy? Weigh in gone wrong. The story of my conversion to my faith. Let's get a few things clear. How a morbidly obese takes a shower. One single morbidly obese
Yes. I don't know if this is the one, but this is workout slash my food slash boundaries made. And this video has 7,000 views. It's one of her most viewed videos from just 2 weeks ago. So you know this one is special. So she's in her car right now. I know that burns a lot of calories, but let's get to the part where she gets out of... Oh, we got the workout happening, guys. Hang on. Let me play some fucking Kanye West. Listen, we're listening to Spock's beard right now, but fuck it. Hang on. I know the perfect song for right now. Some of you know what's coming. If you know me and you've been in a Discord call with me before. You just popped into the Kanye West workout plan, everybody.
I put that in there and then also...
Oh yeah, she's bouncing. She's getting that workout going. One and two and three and four and... Yeah, get that shit moving. Yeah, get moving. Don't drop the blunt and disrespect the weed. Was she playing Dance Dance Revolution? Is that what's happening? Yes, I know there's no audio because she's playing her own shitty workout music. Which is probably also going to get me copyright claimed. So I might as well get claimed for playing some fucking Kanye instead. Yeah, dude. Oh, yeah. You get that workout going. Work out! This is more... You know what? This is less of a workout than me fighting a final boss in a Yakuza game. This is less of a workout than me playing, like, fucking Wonderwall on guitar. This is less of a workout than me grabbing this bottle of whiskey right now.
Jesus Christ.
Cover your mouth like you got SARS. Okay. That's how you work out, everybody. You might start to wonder why you're also not losing weight. And the answer is, you know, Kanye still messes with a big girl, so maybe Amy's got a chance. I don't know. But the answer is, you just don't believe enough, okay? You're not hitting your kids enough to lose weight when you do this tiny, minor, not even a workout. Yeah, dude, get that money. Get that fucking money. She wanna talk it out, but ain't nothing to talk about unless... Yeah. You work that shit out, Amy. Okay. Alright. Okay. I think that will about do us for this video. In fact, I think that might about do us for the stream. Jeez. Is she still working out? Can we listen to the... Oh, fuck. I lost it. Can we listen to the audio at any point? No, she's still got that happening. Does she stop doing that at some point? Medicine.
For breakfast.
And now we've jumped to a K's cooking video, everybody. Here's some semen.
This morning I had tuna, one boiled hard egg.
Wow, now I know how people feel when I show them my tuna melts and they, like, throw up violently because tuna melts don't photograph well. Now I understand
and
it.
An 8-ounce glass of milk. What, 1%.
Hey, people! I'm back cooking again!
For lunch, I had a pita sandwich.
Wow, that definitely looks like it's just been fucking nutted on.
Which was basically a salad in a pita bread, a whole wheat pita bread at that, 2 tablespoons of poppy seed dressing, and then a whole bunch of vegetables.
Guys, think dinner, we should do the MRI video?
Like a vegetable.
You think before we leave, we should do the I got stuck in an MRI video? You think that's necessary viewing before we go?
All thrown together and made into...
You have to put on some fucking Opeth or something to get through that shit.
Soup. It was delicious and it was 0 calories.
Yes, we need to watch that.
It was all the...
All right, I guess we're getting some Opeth music. Hang on. Amy... I like how this stream has just turned into my excuse to play copyrighted music behind this lady talking over it. Amy Ramadan, MRI. Got stuck in the MRI machine! Ba-da-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da- morning! Welcome to Amy's wonderful life journey, everybody. I'm sure nothing's gonna go wrong here, and this vlog is going to be perfectly fine. This is probably gonna be the last one we look at tonight, and I really want you all to savor this in its natural habitat. This is gonna be an exciting one, chat. I hope you're ready for this.
Thursday. Oh, so today is a great day, and guess what? I have my state back, so I can actually start vlogging again. Whoop, whoop. Anyways, I am actually on my way. Well, Ollie's gonna drop me off. I have to go down to the hospital because they are going to do x-rays of my back to see about the spine, why my lower back is hurting like it is, and then from there, if they don't see what they're looking for, which my doctor said he doesn't think it's going to show on x-ray what he's technically looking for, which would
guys,
be a
the secret
fracture,
is to not even listen to whatever the fuck she's saying and just listen to the opener from the background.
To have that done on my back. And also, I think we're going to try and get the MRI done of my legs as well, since I've been having so many issues between my...
Okay, come on, we're not doing this for 20 fucking minutes. Let's move along with this.
Then I will eat dinner, but I'm not like, oh my god, I gotta eat it, like a big portion of it or anything. Let's see here. Thursday?
Please,
night?
Can we have actual fantasy? Because
yes.
We're gonna be claimed
no,
anyways.
Night.
I mean,
Wednesday
maybe.
Night.
I'm gonna be honest with you, I don't stan actual fantasy as far as Arion albums go, but I can play with you back on planet Earth. That's a pretty good song. Or Abbey of Sin.
We ran errands all day Wednesday, just taking care of everything, paying bills, you know, the first month's worth of things that have to be done. And so by the time we got home,
okay,
we
fuck
were
you
exhausted.
Up, never mind.
The kids were just tired. We wanted to give baths and...
Fine, we'll put the volume up, whatever.
So we went ahead.
It's the end of the stream. Like, let him claim me. It's fine.
A very long time. I can, you know, eat like the broccoli and beef and, you know, make it as the best choices I can for eating something that's probably not the best choice. So we went ahead and we got that. And I split my whole meal with Omar and Esra, so I didn't eat as much as I would normally eat, but about an hour
thoughts
after
on my
I
house
ate,
on Mars
so
they'll all never know.
Oh my god,
the ocean breeze.
I was so sick, my stomach was killing me, and I told Ali, I said, you know, because we haven't eaten out in like, I want to say almost close to 4 months. We haven't really like ate out like a fat.
Yeah, I should hope nobody's eating you out. I mean, what
food restaurant type thing. And I saw a flower on my face, and so I told him, I said, you know, I think honestly our bodies
actual
are
fantasy is fine, it's
anymore.
Not one of the
I
best come
think
on
think that we have eaten home-cooked meals so much that
play the game dude theme
literally made us ill, both of us. We were both just not feeling well. So I told him, I said, never again. If I want broccoli and beef, I will make that at home. I am not trying to do
I'm that. Never eating another vegetable again. Oh, god damn it. Fuck that.
On Thursday night, and then our Wednesday night. Thursday morning, I got up and I weighed, and I was so mad at myself because I got two.
Guys,
I went
the
down
prog
to
is about to happen.
467 went back up to 469.
I'm not even paying attention to the video anymore.
I don't know what happened other than I ate the wrong foods. And so, yeah, I was a little upset.
Yes, you ate the wrong foods. That's usually what tends to happen when you fuck up your diet.
And that's just what I'm going to do. So I made a poor choice of what to eat. It made me sick. It gained a little bit of weight, which I can foresee most likely a lot of it is probably water, because Panda obviously has a lot of sodium, and my body doesn't handle sodium very well. And also, that was another thing too, is I noticed about an hour to an hour.
Really? Because you sure seem salty with all the shit I've seen you upload recently.
The most excrucial, painful, horrible, I don't even know what else I could say, headache.
The song is Abbey of Sin by Arion.
Times. Like, you guys gotta check it out, it's pretty good. And this was close to a migraine, but I could tell the difference. I just... Ooh, girl.
Excrucial, guys.
I had a headache all day yesterday, and now that I'm on different meds, I can't take like an ibuprofen like I used to, so I had to wait it out. But that's all right. It's okay. I'm gonna survive. Like I said, I live, I learn, and I learn my mistake. So, or I learned my lesson, not my mistake. Well, I guess you could say both. But anyway, so back to the whole bread thing. So I just make that for the kids and for Ollie, because they like to have it with their dinners and stuff. So, and I've pretty much, now I've switched anything that they eat with, like, bread or pasta.
Shut up, I'm not singing. Fuck you, we're watching the videos.
Depends on what it is, and if it's something that I can just switch it out totally, then I'll just do that. But if it's something that it's kind of hard to really switch it out, I will have a little bit of pasta.
Yeah, eat that pasta, queen!
And that's kind of what I...
Shovel down that spaghetti!
Anything with, like, a lot of bread or rice or pasta, I just make sure that I have a side salad. Or, like, today I was making the bread, and I was getting a little bit hungry. Not too bad, but just a little bit. And I was like, you know, not hungry enough to eat a meal, but I'm hungry enough to need a snack. So I just went in the
this lady's gonna eat a meal, everybody.
Big old English cucumbers, popped it open, cut it down to, for me and the kids, and we sat there and we ate cucumber for snack slash my lunch. And then I made them a turkey sandwich on the side, and it's perfectly fine. So I'm learning as I go along, and that's just what I'm going to continue to do, and I'm just going to do things that fit.
I'm officially drunk enough to just, you know, be like singing what during the stream, right? It's fine.
Hopefully, by the time I go back to the doctors, I will be told that I am back under my numbers, that I'm not diabetic.
Who gives a shit? Are you going to get actually stuck in this machine, or what? This video goes for 22 minutes, and at no point does she get into how she got... Well, she probably does get into it, but she doesn't show video of it, goddammit. We expected video. We came to this thing expecting video, goddammit. Oh, man, I feel fucking offended. I feel like I've been violated. Not as bad as her children probably do, but it's fine. So... You know, I feel like that's probably it for Amy Ramadan. You know, she's a pretty interesting case. We got some footage of her potentially beating her kids, or at the very least, some interesting fucking sounds happening around her while she's disciplining her kids. I don't know. It sounded like she hit her kids. I don't know about that one, but, you know, she might hit them with a fucking spoon, too. I'm not making any accusations. I'm not making any allegations. I don't really know what's going on in this lady's life outside of what she shows on YouTube, but... You know, that's pretty much the whole point, honestly, is just showing what she shows on YouTube, what her whole thing is, what she wants to display to people and act like is, you know... I don't know. Her perfect family life, I guess. Showing people the child abuse. I'm not sure. Not sure why you would do that, but I mean, I guess that's an option. Let me see. I need to catch up on a couple super chats here. Actually, before I catch up on super chats, I'll listen to this shit. Man, I don't even care if I get copyright claimed, it's fine. Anyways. Sorry, I got drunk a little while ago, and now I'm just having fun. So this is just a fun stream for me. We went from, you know, we went from like a Sangi-esque. Hang on, where is our patron saint of fucking weirdos? Where did he go? I apparently deleted him from the thing. That's wrong. Where is our fucking patron saint? Hang on. He needs to be back here. He needs to bless the stream with his visage. Yes! There is our boy! The patron saint rises! Yes! He watches over all, everybody. But, you know, yeah, we started with, like, the child abuse. This has been a real roller coaster of a stream, if you think about it. Because we went from just, hey, this lady's kind of funny looking, I guess, to sort of, hey, this lady's a child abuser, to, like, hey, this lady's also kind of, like, crazy and a bit of a narcissist and, I don't know, might scam people. There's a lot of layers to Amy Ramadan. She's like an onion in the way that she smells bad. I mean, what? Let me get some more fair use music queued up here, because we need some good fair use music. That's right. Stuff that won't get me yeeted off of YouTube just for enjoying my life. There you go. Okay, let's take a look at a couple of these. Let's see. Gotta catch up. I think that was the last one I read. Okay, $2 from Rio Illustrates. Dreams on PS4 releases on Valentine's Day. Are you playing? Dreams isn't already out? I know about it. Is that not already out? Okay, I know Vinny's played it like 20 streams already, but... yeah, Dreams seems pretty cool. I think I might buy that. I could be down for that. $5 from Sean Hiruki. Hell yeah, I love Musou games, and Koei makes some great games. Their Gundam Musou are great, and Dynasty Warriors 8 is the best in the series. You know, I make jokes about Toei, but honestly, I wish I could get into their games. I just don't like the gameplay very much, but I kind of like the whole... I like the, what is the one they do that's, like, basically the Romance of the Three Kingdoms, but, like, as, like, a Musou? I kind of like that sort of ancient Chinese history shit. It's kind of cool. So I could be down for some of that. Also, maybe learning more about Nobunaga and shit. It could be kind of cool. $2 from Ale Titan. Some people addicted to having babies. Mental ill. Yeah, I get that feeling a little bit when I watch Amy, that she's... more than anything, she wants to be a parent. Not a parent. She wants to be a mommy. She wants people to look at her as the, you know, mommy. And the mommy to children, to babies specifically. Which, I mean, I don't know. I feel like it's a bit of a toxic... bit of a toxic thing. I don't know. $5 from B. Key. Video about a Muslim and the child abuse comes as a surprise. Oh, no. Oh no, we're bullying, chat. Oh no. Listen, hey, whatever she wants to believe is fine, but when she starts, like, smacking her kids, that's when it stops being cool, okay? Bully! By the way, Bully Stream Part 3 pretty soon. We gotta do fucking Part 3 of Bully Stream. I wanna do it when I'm drunk, because I know that's gonna make for the greatest of Bully Streams. But yeah, we gotta do some more Bully at some point. Onyx1937 with $2. Lord Bear is Irate Bear, now called Irate Alex. Well, my name's not Alex, but it's better than Irate Gamer, so I take it. It's fine. $5 from Alex Lynette. Hey, fellow weeb. What kind of anime do you weeb out? I'm a normie and enjoy FMA Brotherhood and Shield Hero. I have never heard of Shield Hero. I don't watch that much anime, to be honest. To be completely honest, the thing that finally... like, okay... I watched a bit of anime. I was a big fan of Berserk, the Berserk anime. Not really the manga, I never really got into it, but The anime, at least, I watched a lot of. I watched that all the way through a few years ago. But, like, I wasn't a big weeb until I fucking played Yakuza. Until I got into the shonen shit, I was like, you know what? The moment that I fucking finished my first Yakuza game, and I realized just how fucking hype it was for dudes to rip off their shirts and fight each other, I realized suddenly that both the WWE is valid and also anime. And I started watching some Dragon Ball and some other shit, and I was like, you know what? I finally get this. I love it. So as far as me with anime goes, I would seriously suggest an anime called Monster, which is a very non-standard anime about like a doctor and Nazis and stuff like that. It's pretty cool. I need to get back into that actually. But also I would suggest Hokuto no Ken because just watch Hokuto no Ken, you fucking casual. Let's see. $2 from Papa Yang Bang. Is it okay to like JoJo's in this stream? I mean, I'm not the biggest JoJo guy. I hung out with this girl who made me watch JoJo, and I kind of started to like it, and I kind of just started to like her, and then some shit fell apart, and it kind of sucks. But I mean, honestly, JoJo reminded me of like a weird, cool, like, weird fucking, I don't know, it's like a weird Castlevania thing where it's basically like you know, the eternal Trevor the eternal Belmont of Joestar facing against the eternal Dracula Dio, you know what I mean? Like there's something there that I kind of like. I feel like I could get into Dio, but I never really have. I mean, not Dio. I feel like I could get into Dio, honestly. But, I mean, I feel like I could get into JoJo, but I never really have. Let's see. $10 from Good Clara. Stop reading our minds. I don't know what I did, but I'm sorry. Cecile A. with $2. Kate Winslet, do I need to get the spoon? You know, we didn't watch that one. Should we watch that one? You guys want to watch one more video before we're done? You guys want to watch one last final Kate Winslet edit before we're done? Why do I ask? I know what the answer is, you fuckers. You just want me to... Oh, listen to that good shit before we get to it. You just want me to fucking suffer, you fuckers. Okay, it's fine. Let's do one more. Let's do one more video. What is it? It was the Kate Winslet video, and it was not in my back menu on here. Hang on. Kate Winslet. Guys, everybody who already left the stream because I'm doing super chats and also I'm a drunk fucker. Guess what? You're gonna miss one final video. I bet you fucking feel bad. We're gonna watch one last video and you're all gonna feel bad and you're gonna like complain that I only make streams now and I don't do videos because you missed a video. That's what's gonna happen. You know what? That's what's gonna fucking happen. So this is Do I Need to Get the Spoon by our girl Amy. And let's see. Let's see what happens. A minute and 50 seconds. What is this? What is this? Let's see in full screen. Three weeks after uploading a video where she hits her kid, this train wreck gets on FB and baits for ass pats. Guys. Guys, I stand up to bullying. Wait, did we watch this? I think we did watch this. Hang on. We did watch this. Okay, we already saw this one. Come on now. People telling me to watch this video. I know that's an outdated super chat, but it's fine. Let's make up for it by watching one final one. This one's called The Last Ninja, and I need to see what this is about. Oh.
centuries ago.
Kimosabe, I, Komaki, have come to deliver unto you the secret technique of the Komaki shot stopper.
Feudal Japan was divided into warring armies.
Shut up! I know I'm drunk! Fuck you!
Ninjas for their lords, called ninja. Masters of the martial arts, disguise and illusion. They were seemingly able to disappear like wisps of shadows. The time has come for me, your father, to reveal to you.
So you're a top secret lieutenant of the Kido clan in Osaka, and you get visited one night on your secret compound of like trained assassin ninja men and samurais and shit. You get visited and you see in the shadows.
The time has come for me, your father, to reveal to
and you just get filled with a fear that you've never felt before.
Of ninjutsu, to use them to oppose men of evil and to have no fear.
Skunk butthole.
You will learn all of our secrets. Your destiny is to be the last of the ninja.
Wu-Tang!
She's gonna be the last of the ninja, ladies and gentlemen. I know I believe in her.
By the way, I would just like to say,
as videos are being shared here of Amber Lynn, I have been told to talk about Amber Lynn before, and I have never really fallen into it that much. I did talk about her a couple of times. Talked about her on a cooking stream. I talked about her on a video, of course, the mukbang video with Fuzu. But yeah, I never really got that interested in Amberlynn Reed, you know, because she never really did anything quite as fucked up as like a person like Amy Ramadan. You know what I mean? Like a person like her, I can really sink my teeth into her disgusting bullshit that she's done. But like, I don't know, Amberlynn Reed, she's just a bit of a fucker. Who cares? She's just a bit of a fucker. She's just a general fucker. Who cares? Nothing of interest to really say. Anyways, we were going to watch a different bonus video. We wound up watching a completely separate bonus video. It's fine. We got the ninja experience, and I feel pretty good about it. So, let's get this music going again. Yeah. There you go. $2. No. $10. Wait, I'm still wrong. Hang on, let me catch up. $2 from Meeb. Should we have a fair use Sangi? Well, we got a fair use Sangi now, you know? That's what's important, is that he comes through in the end. $10 from Brimstone ZV. I'm going to keep hitting you until you stop crying. Stop crying, tiny child. Allow me to beat you until you understand. $2 from Mama Catswell. This is why Jabba the Hutt shouldn't have kids. Ooh, deep cut. Oh, that's bully stream shit. I like it. I mean, I don't like it. That's bad. I shun you. Very bad. $2 from Seth Stargunner. Click, clack, cloom. She's coming with the spoon. Very good. $2 from Elizabeth Schwartz. Claw Daddy explaining how to be a good parent. You know, I'm not a parent, but I feel like my dad was a pretty good parent. And I feel like in general, all it takes to be a good parent is to generally be a decent human being. And I don't know, I feel like Amy might be failing that test slightly, but that's just my opinion. Definitely not a bully stream. $2 from Uboa. Really saddens me to see how uncaring she is. I agree. you know. You see a lot of these, like, mother channels, these sort of, like, look at me, I'm a mommy, everybody. Don't you relate to me because I'm also a mommy? And it's like, I don't know. Shouldn't you look at your children as human beings who you have just created, who you now have to be responsible for in the way that they turn out in their life? Like, shouldn't you look at that a little more than just, hey, I get to be a mommy now, woohoo! You know what I mean? Like, that feels a little bit disrespectful. I don't know. Let's see, $2 from Mega Doomed. Sickos can have a little bullying as a treat. That's right. That's right. I mean, I'm into getting bullied if you're an attractive woman, at least. That's the important thing. But I'm into getting bullied. Maybe she is too, you know? We can't kink shame. Maybe she's also into getting bullied. But this isn't a bully stream, so this definitely wouldn't play into that kink. So it's fine. $5 from Rezek Zero. I bet she's a fan of party cheese salad. Oh, come on now. That's a little bit harsh. I don't know if you want to be saying that about a person. That's going a little bit far right there. Get a couple more songs happening here. Yeah. Get some more stupid bullshit playing. Play the fucking theme of Eggman. It's fine. Okay. Oh, god damn it. I fucked up. There you go. You're good. Let's see. $5 from Staceface. No message. Thank you very much. I hope you had a good stream. $5 from Strange Parallels. Thank you, Claw Man, for giving me something to watch while I work late weeding books from the library I run. :O. Well, you know what? Massive props to librarians. I sure find them hot. I mean, what? But you know, massive props to librarians. You guys have a whole you guys got a whole thing to run, a whole circus. Massive props. I hope you have fun. I hope this stream helped make the Dewey Decimal System a little more bearable for you. You know what I mean? go home. I'm drunk. Shut up. Librarians are hot. Shut up. $20 from Royo Nixon. Hey again. Canada man, late to the stream, but always fun to drop in on the borderline child abuse. Stay golden. Yeah, you know, dude, this channel's all about the fun entertainment of child. You know, I'm not even gonna finish that sentence. It's fine. It's fine. Anyways, I hope you had a good stream, and thank you very much, friend. $5 from Sitters the Inkling. Sitters the Inkling. In other news, Canadian Liberal leader Andrew Wilkinson has been canceled. I don't know what that fucker did, but fuck him. $5 from Spooky Nerdy Skeleton. If you cannot afford or meet the adoption requirements, maybe you shouldn't get a baby. I agree. I think she views the baby as an object. Yes, in my personal opinion, and the personal opinion of a few people that watch the stream currently, I believe that she views the baby as something of an object. More of a status thing. More of a, look at me, I am a mommy with a baby. I am specifically a mommy to a small baby. Rather than caring about the person at the other end of the baby, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know, call me crazy, but I feel like there's something to be said for the human being that becomes of, you know, the baby that you're raising. I feel like you need to account for what adult they'll become, for what kind of human person they will be in the real world for the majority of their life, rather than just parading them around as an accessory. Seems a little wrong to me. Let's see. $5 from, I saw that one already. $2 from Cheesy Lemurs. Would love to see you recreate Kay's fried rice. You know, at some point, I think we might be doing some other Kay stuff before the fried rice, but, maybe at some point. It could definitely happen. I think I would hate myself if I burnt the garlic like that, though, because I'm actually I'm not the greatest of cooks, but at least I know not to burn garlic like that, you know? Let's see. $10 from Goof Troop. I can see the natural maternal instincts. Oh, yeah, dude. She parents like Goofy exists as a Disney character. You know what I mean? Like, just totally C-string. I don't even know what I'm saying. It's fine. $5 from Ultra Neckbeard Supreme. I wanted to donate you a baby, but I don't have one. You'll have to settle for $5. Well, shit, given the way we've seen her treat her children, I mean, $5 might be all that a baby's worth, apparently, according to her. $2 from Distan Dan. Finally, I caught another stream of yours. Well, I hope this one was up to your standards, friend. Rabbi Haim Alderman with $2. Oy vey, guys, we gotta get out of all of this mess. Oh no, we gotta get Allie out of this mess. We're gonna rescue Allie, everybody. We're getting the husband out of this horrible situation. It's gonna be fine. Let's see, $5 from Max R. Does anyone have Does anyone else think she kind of talks like Amberlynn Reed? Yes, a little bit. From the little of Amberlynn that I've seen, I do get a little bit of that. I don't know, that might just be how fat white people talk. I'm not sure. $10 from Jessica Ustis. Can we start using the term skunk thing for women horror cows? Also, emotional support animals are just pets with a special title instead of an animal with months and months of service training. Yes, there is a bit of a difference there between like a legitimate emotional support dog who has legitimately been trained to deal with, you know, humans in a way. There's a bit of a difference between that and like her supposed emotional support skunk. I don't know, guys. I don't know how I feel about that one. But that's fine. Let's see. $2 from Jessica Ustis once again. Wow, I'm burping because of all of the music. Because of all of the devil music I'm listening to. I'm burping like a fucking gout-ridden DSP or something. $2 from Jessica Ustis. Does she scream a la snack bar when she trips? Oh god, we got some bully stream happening. We got some bully stream going on in the chat. Okay, that's fine. You know, that happens. Can't stop everybody. $2 from Aaron P. Thought pigs were haram in Islam. Oh no! You're making the joke I made earlier. Oh god. Oh god. I hope somebody cancels you and forgets that I made the same joke. $2 from Green Thumbs to My Elbows. I heart you. No hetero. No hetero needed, baby. Serb Durbins with £2. What if we dated at KFC? Haha, unless. $2 from Mysterious Senor Hilter. I don't understand. I thought pigs were haram. Guys, stop making the same joke I did. It's gonna make it wrong and bad for me to have said such a thing. Shut up. $2. Thank you, though. $2 from Filthy Casual. Gib Bab for Allah Xmas Plucks. Now that is how you format a YouTube comment. Thank you very much. $5 from Mad Evil Genius. She said it's the baby she always wanted. Would that mean that the others aren't wanted? That's kind of horrible. Yeah, I guess she already had kids, but they weren't quite the baby that she always wanted, you know? So, it's understandable that she just hated those kids instead. Let's see. Papa Yang Bang with $2. Hey, Google! Search for anal vor. He didn't say that. He just said, hey, Google, but it's fine. $2 from Aaron P. Deadwing, have you heard of Pup Schnooter? pup schnooter? What in the fuck is a pup schnooter? Huh. Let's go look that one up real quick. Pup schnooter? Is that how you spell it? Hang on. Okay, that's not how you spell it. Hold the fort. Pup schnooter. Yes, like shooter. Puppy shooter. I don't see anything related to pup schnooter right now. Hang on. Search only for pup schnooter. I don't know, man. That could be a thing at some point if she turns out to be a crazy enough person. Who knows? Let's see. $5 from Devout Blade. I'm sorry, I almost said that wrong. Devout Blade with $5. Funny she's a Muslim and gave her son a Hebrew name. Yeah, it's funny how her Muslim child, Jeremiah, is... Is it Jeremiah or is it Jebediah? I forget. I think it's Jeremiah because she names him Maya. She names the male child Maya and hopes that he has an okay life, I guess. But yeah, I don't know about that one. That's an interesting Hebrew name for a kid. Let's see. $2 from Joseph Resch. She's an outcast from the Hidden Chin Village. Oh man, it feels bad knowing that Vivi's people turned her away, but, you know, it's just all we need to know. $2 from Meeb. So when's the sushi burger stream? I don't think the sushi burger is going to be in a stream, but I can assure you it's going to happen. Your boy Spooky Scary Skeleton has, in fact, donated for that, so that's definitely going to occur. I can promise you that much. As for when it happens, we still need to order edible dirt because actually Skelly's fucking brother made me eat dirt, and then Skelly made me eat fucking sushi bacon cheeseburger. Wow, that's gonna be a waste of a bacon cheeseburger. The only way I can get through that is if I also make delicious bacon cheeseburgers and then just destroy them with some sushi. Just destroy one of them with some sushi. I can eat like three of them and be fine, and then I can be like, hey everybody, so we're making a sushi bacon cheeseburger here. let's see. Catch up with some more super chats here. Crabthulhu. With $10, add to the bull fund, Claw. Need to make sure you are calm enough so you don't abuse any children. Hey, man, listen, I don't have any need to abuse children. I'm firmly in the boat of consensual non-consent. I mean, what? Shut the fuck up. I didn't say anything. To $5 from Dis Dan Dan. If you don't think you can handle kids, then don't have kids. Also, it's the internet. No one cares if some words on the screen make you go, "Ah!" Yeah, I mean, it's the internet. Claw dropping his kinks out here. Shut up! $5 from Distan Dan. Club Pop, you should try checking out your chat filters. For some reason, I can't send a super chat when swearing. /. I'm sorry to hear that. I don't know about chat filters. I'll look into that. Thank you for suggesting that I look into that. I know there's a difference between live chat and top chat. I think maybe some words YouTube might just not want you to say. So, like, I don't know. Try to get around it as much as you can. You know what I mean? But, like, the sentiment can still be there. Let's see. $2 from Josh Strife. Salila Sawarim Nashira Luda Ali Akbar. Oh god. Well, the stream just got banned for terrorism, everybody. Thank you, good night. £2 from Ethan Alfassi. She's probably hibernating right now. Well, I don't think so. I'm the bear of the two of us, and she's posted videos recently, so I don't know about that one. Distan Dan with $5. I got a Photoshop certification test to take tomorrow, so I'm going to sleep since it's almost 10. Good night, everybody. Don't beat your kids, y'all. Okay, emoji. Remember, everybody, it's okay as long as you don't beat your kids. $2 from Genius Khan. I won't marry, so I can't divorce. You know, that's true galaxy brain thinking right there. $2 from Deplorabology. Women talking without a man's permission is haram. Hey, how did you get into my secret fetishes? I mean, what? Shut up. $2 from Bis Ditch. Asshole! Get that one spaced out in multiple spaces right there. Shut up, chat. Shut the fuck up. Puckish Rogue with $5. No message. Thank you very much, Puckish Rogue. $2 from Kyle Newhouse. Speaking of Yakuza, should I get 6-0 or Judgment? Well, you definitely shouldn't start with 6. I don't know what would make you think that's a good idea. As for Yakuza games, RGG games in general, I would say Judgment. Big fucking shoutouts to Judgment as literally one of the greatest stories that I've fucking seen in gaming from last year. Judgment is great. Judgment is almost like the Yakuza formula fucking mastered. Where it's like, it doesn't have Kiryu, he's great, I'm a Kiryu stan, I'm a Majima stan, but like, I don't know, the core tenets of the story are like, it's some crazy conspiracy shit, but it's believable, and it's understandable, and at the end of it, at the end of the entire game, you're like, you know what? Yeah, I can see how this could have somewhat realistically happened. There's a couple of things that don't make a lot of sense, but I would say if you're into story, Judgment is a great place to start. If you're into, like, Bishonen fucking dudes fighting with their shirt off, though, I would totally tell you to start with either Yakuza 0 or Kiwami. That's my opinion. I gotta say, though, another decent place to start. Strange for me to say this, but another decent place to start is Yakuza 5. I know that sounds weird, but it starts in like the end of Kiryu's story, and I don't know, in a way, just seeing this dude who's like been relegated to driving a cab, he's like a former ex-Yakuza guy who's like really important, and he's just like, fuck it, I'm gonna go drive a cab instead. I don't know, that's kind of an interesting, like, film setup, in my opinion, you know? It's kind of, that's some interesting shit. I would love to see that expanded upon. But there's me going off and on Yakuza stuff. Hey guys, you learned the secret. You want me to fucking ramble about some dumb bullshit? Make me talk about Yakuza, it's fine. Let's see. But yeah, as for this person who asked Kyle Newhouse, definitely don't play 6. Oh my god. Even as a fan of the Yakuza games, 6 isn't that good. I would not start with 6. Start with like 0 or Kiwami and then like move on. I don't know. 6 should be one of the last ones you play. 6 is kind of okay, but it's not very good. Anyways. $5 from Onyx1937. If people want a good documentary on her, they should go watch Irate Alex's video on her. Give him some love. He's a great guy. Thanks for the stream. Well, you know what? I've never heard of Irate Alex, but his name reminds me of Irate Gamer, and I don't like that. But you know what? I feel like he's probably better than Irate Gamer just from the outset, because, I mean, we're grading on an upward curve here. If you're better than Irate Gamer, that's all I ask for as a person, as a human being. $2 from Neon Lemmy Koopa. She looks like a marshmallow in a hijab. Oh god, we're getting into the bully stream stuff here, everybody. Hang on, we need some more music. We need some more music to make sure this is not a bully stream. Yeah, got unknown from ME in here. That's right. That's some legitimate... That is some legitimate music that's definitely not a meme and nothing more. Hang on. There you go. Get that casino shit going. $2 from Sean Hiruki. Literally a ball with legs. Oh no. Na 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 Katamari Damacy. I'm sorry. Not a bully stream. Shut up. It's fine. Not a bully stream. Let's see. $2 from Puckish Rogue. Here's your super pal. Two yum yums. I'm really sad to hear that apparently Godwin's video on Lee got taken down. I wonder if I can find that again. Did anybody, if anybody who knows what I'm talking about right now when I say, here's your super pal, when I talk about Godwin's video on Big Man Lee. Does anybody know the video I'm talking about? Is there like an archive of that that I can link to somewhere? Because apparently the actual video got taken down, sadly. Godwinson got yeeted, I believe. So maybe we can find like a replacement for that. I don't know. Let's see. $2 from Adorable Cockroach. No message. Thank you, Cockroach. I hope that you dodge many a nuclear explosion. $2 from Neon Lemmy Koopa. This woman is a contradiction. Pork is haram. You know, we've heard that joke at least 3 times now. One of which has been from me. And you know what? I feel like it's been done better each time after I said it. So thank you for sharing. $2 from Fidgety Penguin. How much money do I have to pay for ASMR? Ooh, woo. I mean, if you guys want me to do a singing stream, I guess I could do that. I could totally do a stream where I just go off on some fucking songs that I like, but then I'd get fucking copyright struck. So who gives a shit? Whatever. Fuck you. I don't like songs. I don't like music. Fuck you. Shut up, Frozen Waifu. I'll give you as much fucking ASMR as you can deal with, you dumb bitch. Anyways, let's see. $2 from Blue Satoshi. Dear Lord, I can hear the fat in her voice. Oh, that's offensive. Somebody's gonna get mad about that one. Oh boy. Oh no. Somebody's gonna get mad about that one. $2 from Festerizzy69. Off topic, but are you gonna watch Sonic Friday? What is that, like a Sonic version of Friday? From Rebecca Black? I don't know. I don't know what Sonic Friday is, but boy, can I ever tell you. After Sonic for Real Justice, am I ever fucking ready to never talk about Sonic again? Let's see. $5 from Sean Hiruki. Oh no, I'm wrong. Hang on. $2 from Test Subject 306. Onion Boy used a VR porn maker for his animation. I don't believe that. I feel like a VR porn maker would look a little more human, you know? Feel like you would at least be able to tell the humanity a little better. Let's see. $5 from Sean Hiruki. Dynasty Warriors is the Three Kingdoms Musou. Also, Koei does strategy games. Romance of the Three Kingdoms 14 comes out in the West on 28th. Wait, they're the ones who do the Romance of the Three Kingdoms game. Okay. So Toei just has like a fucking stranglehold on the entire Chinese history demographic. Okay. I'm pretty down for that like pre-communism China history stuff. You know what I mean? Like, I make some jokes, but, like, legitimately, a thing I have to say without any hint of irony is, like, I am fascinated by China before they became crazy and fascist. or socialist or whatever the fuck they are. I don't care. They're bad people. But before they were crazy, China was really cool, dude. Like, man, Three Kingdoms Musou. I think I need to play that, even if I don't care about Dynasty Warriors. Whatever. Let's see. $10 from Chloe. Starting the booze fund. Wow, I can speak. Starting the booze fund for Bully Stream. Also, JoJo is top tier. I mean, JoJo seemed pretty cool, I won't lie. I liked what I saw of it, but it also... I hate JoJo because of every fucking idiot on Twitter who's like... who hears me talk about sheer heart attack or roundabout, and they're like, hey, is that a JoJo reference? Hey, I hear you talking about the band King Crimson. Literally one of the most influential progressive rock bands ever to exist. But I hear you talk about King Crimson. You're definitely a JoJo fan, right? Because they also made a King Crimson reference. Therefore, you're a shut up, JoJo fans. Nobody cares that much. Anyways. You guys just made me mad, you fuckers. $2 from Meeb. If we make art, is Twitter the place to link it? You can link it if you at DeadwingDork. You can link it on my Twitter. I might see it. There's a chance that I might miss it. So there is that chance. But for fan art, I tend to be like a little bit especially aware. So if you do send it, I will probably retweet it. And if not, if you're a part of the Discord already, please be sure to send it in the art and selfies section. Because there's some really cool people over there and very, very supportive people. You might get the impression from my streams that my Discord is like just a bunch of people being edgy meme lords. But honestly, like... dude, the fucking Sicko Army is like one of the fucking most caring, nicest people, most nicest groups on YouTube, you know what I mean? Like, we might not be the fastest growing, we might not be up there with Greg, with fucking Danny Gonzalez, that shill. I'm joking, I love Danny, shut up. But we might not be up there with Danny, but you know what? We're up there with other fat Muslim ladies who abuse their children. And that's all that really counts if you think about it. So anyways, let's get back to these super chats. I'm going off the rails here because I drank a little bit too much and now I'm listening to Sonic music. And it's getting me all nipply, you know what? It's getting me all riled up. Let's see. $2 from Cheesy Lemurs once again. Maybe a video about the Slayton sisters. I have talked about them in the past in streams. They're not shitty enough human beings that I want to talk about them in their own right. You know what I mean? Like, I'm okay with bringing them up a little bit in passing as like a bad YouTube cooking kind of thing. But, they don't feel like the most perfect of people, but at the same time, I feel bad about shitting on them because I don't know. Here I come, rougher than the rest of them. Let's see. The Slayton sisters. I do feel a little bad about shitting on them, though. To answer your question, video about Slayton sisters, at some point, maybe, but like... I don't know, they're kind of just some fat bitches trying to have fun, you know? Like, it's not really anything too malicious. I can't really, like... I don't want to go full leafy here and just, like, shit on people for being cringy. I want to shit on people for being a little more than cringy. Like, the kringe is an excellent topping to go over and above the child abuse. But the Amy Ramadan child abuse scandal is truly the main course of the stream. So, you know, that's just the way it be. $10 from Erasmataz Bean. Hope your drinks were cold, your laughs were full, and your heart a little warmer than it has been in the past. Happy trails, Claw. Also, I would also bang Dio, speaking as a mega JoJo fan. I misspoke, but you know what? I would too. You're right. $2 from Shadowhawk X13. Look up Lunatic Larry sometime. Also, Locust Toy Box. These are some interesting new suggestions. What do we got going on here? Lunatic Larry. Is that anything like Lucky Larry? Is that anything like our boy Lucky Larry Silverstein? Lunatic Larry. What we got? Lunatic Larry on Marvel's database? Wattpad? It's fine. You know what? I'll bookmark this one. It's fine. And what was the other one you mentioned? Locust Toy Box. Fucking, who is this person? Hang on. Shadowhawk X13 with some crazy fucking suggestions right now. What do we got? Locust Toy Box? Oh my god, I don't like the sound of that. Okay, it's a musician. Okay, he's a musician. Okay, it's fine. He's just an avant-garde, like, hipster musician. That's okay. I can get behind that. That's fine. Locust Toy Box doesn't seem to be too much to make fun of. Let me see here. $5 from Sleepy Pupper. I miss your streams sometimes because of video games. I'm sad, so I will watch the full thing alone with junk food. Also, hi, everyone. Stay awesome. Hello, everybody. I hope you feel awesome. Bit of a burp there. That's fine. Sleepy Pupper, I hope you enjoyed the stream, though. I hope you were able to focus somewhat. You know, the most important thing you can remember at a certain point is that all of the people around you are wrong. And you're not wrong. And that's the most important thing you can remember. That's what all the lolcows have taught me, at least. Also, Kazuma Kiryu taught me that if you get mad enough, you can get surrounded by a blue flame. And then do, like, magic murder moves on people that somehow don't actually kill them. So, you could also do that. That's also good. Let me see here. $2 from Rezek Zero. You're fun when you're drunk, Claw. Great streams. No, I feel pretty fun tonight. I'm glad that you feel that way. Thank you. $2 from Darkbreaker 97. You gonna be good for games after stream, buddy? Oh, I think so. I gotta fucking order some Chinese food or some shit. So I don't know. I might be down for some. What was the name of that stupid fucking Jackbox rapper game that was terrible and bad because everybody voted for fucking Mev and not me? I mean, what? $2 from Neon Lemmy Koopa. Beat your meat, not your kids. That's right. God gave you meat so you could beat it. He even made it rhyme, you fuckers. And yet you still blame your kids for all of your problems. What's wrong with you, you fuckers? $2 from Max R. It's fine on a shirt for merch. I'd buy it. Listen, it's fine, okay? Don't even worry about it. It's okay. It's fine. She's just abusing her kids a little bit. It's okay. It's fine. Razzmatazz Bean with $15. As a JoJo fan and also a fan of prog rock, I understand and apologize on behalf of all JoJo fans. Yeah, you know, like, it'd be like that, dude. Like, you're a fan of JoJo, and then every other person like you just starts making fucking comments every time a Queen song is brought up. Or a King Crimson. Imagine being King Crimson and literally your entire catalog has just turned into, hey, is this a JoJo reference? Man, rest in peace, Klinge Crimson, my favorite band. Rest in peace, King Crimson. Yeah. People like this can kind of twist the fair use YouTube thing to their advantage in a way where it's like, look at me, I'm making fair use. I'm talking about how I abused a child and abducted a child who I technically don't own over some nice music, which I totally own the copyright to. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know. If it's a shithead like me who's talking over stuff with music, then you can probably feel good about giving them money or something. But if it's a shithead who just completely reappropriates the thing for their own thing, I don't know. We're just going with what people have told me, though. Just going with some choice chat caps, you know what I mean? And we got $2 from Jessica Ustis. Check out Purple Kecleon. It's a wild ride. Purple Kecleon. Okay. At the risk of this sounding like some fucking furry shit, Purple Kecleon. Oh god, she's got her own chat. It's Floriverse. Oh, you're talking about Floriverse. Okay, that makes sense. It's fine. All right, Floriverse. Yeah, she's a crazy cunt. Hey, guess what? This stream's not directed at Floriverse, so she can't call me out if I say, hey, bitch, you're a bit of a crazy cunt, and nobody likes you because you're a fucking psycho. It would be bad if I called her out for that, but that's fine. This channel's not a bully channel, so it's okay. Let me see here. 50 PHP from Smug Hat Kid. I'm sorry, Smug Hat Kid. I'm not sure how much that currency is worth. That might be worth quite a lot, and I should give you more praise, but, I catch you today, but you ending the stream. Don't even worry about it, Smug Hat Kid. You're gonna get to see the whole stream later. This stuff's going up. This is all fine. I would like to make one final mention as we wind down the stream, because this is one of the final super chats. We're about to be done with this. I would like to make one final mention that this genuinely is not meant to be a bully stream. I'm not meaning to bully this person. I'm not meaning to attack them for their beliefs. I'm not meaning to attack her for her religion or her sexuality or anything like that. I'm merely showing some clips of some footage that she has posted herself. In a couple of cases, there's some memes. There's a couple of memes that are not posted by her. But for the most part, when I talk about Yakuza, when I stream about Yakuza, that kind of shit, this whole thing, what is beeping now? Something's fucked up. Good, just opened fucking Premiere by mistake. But when I talk about, you know, Yakuza, when I talk about any of this shit, I don't know why I'm talking about Yakuza right now. I guess I've got it on my brain. But the point is, when I talk about this shit, I'm not bullying people, you know? I'm merely trying to get you all to understand that this is what this lady is posting on the internet. And if there wasn't so much of this, there wasn't so much for me to go, wait, hang on a second, this is a little fucked up, then, you know, it might be fine, and I might be able to get back into the game. Honestly, I gotta be honest, after this stream, I'm probably gonna be playing some Spyro Reignited Trilogy. I'm gonna be honest. It's a good fucking series. That crazy bitch from before talked about them. Now we're talking about a different bitch. But you know what? It's fine. She abuses her crazy fake dragon people. And Amy abuses her real human people. Allegedly, We're not making any accusations. Let me see here. $5 from Kitsune Kinomi. Does it make it better that JoJo introduced me to prog rock? Yeah, a little bit. I do have to give a little bit of credit to the people who got into it from listening to Roundabout or whatever. JoJo doesn't like exclusively do prog rock, but if you're a JoJo fan and you haven't listened to Tarkus by ELP yet, then you're a problem. You are literally a human problem. You're the equivalent of one of Amy's gas passes. I'm sorry I made you think of that, but yes, you're a problem. So culture yourself, you fucking swine. Let me see here. $10 from Razmataz Bean. The loving nature of Araki's homages in JoJo's is lost on people who don't know about the music, and I can just take solace in bonding with an old Japanese mangaka over shared love of old jams. Yes, that's what's important. You might not like JoJo, you might not listen to the music, but man, all it takes is to be down for the same music, you know? And, like, you can fucking get into that mangaka's headspace. Anyways, I'm gonna get into some fucking weeaboo shit. If I'm not careful, I'm gonna accidentally stream the entire Yakuza movie. Hey, guys, did you know that there is a movie based on Yakuza? There's also a fucking stage play based on Yakuza, and it's been English translated on YouTube, so you can go and watch that. Personally, myself, tonight, I think I'm going to be watching the movie based on Yakuza and just marveling at how terrible it might be. Yeah, that'll about do it for the stream. I'd like to thank you all once again for stopping by. This has been a pretty fun time. Despite the child abuse and the morbid obesity and whatnot, I had a pretty good time. And I feel like you guys might enjoy this one too, if you get to play it. I'd like to just say, as a big fan of the Yakuza games, to just like briefly shout out my shit again. You guys got to check out Zero or Kiwami, or even if you are currently on a PS Now membership and you don't play Yakuza 4 or 5, you're a very bad person, and I disagree with you as a human. But anyways, me weebing out about some shit I like. Some crazy beauty vlogger who beats her kids. Penis. Forever. Tran.